San Diego, California, dressed in its finest for Super Bowl 32. Qualcomm Stadium awaits the Denver Broncos and the defending champion Green Bay Packers. Hello, everyone, and indeed, this will be a battle of quarterbacks, and if history repeats, a quarterback probably will be the most valuable player. Brett Favre, the league's best player, three consecutive years, never happened before, against the sentimental favorite, John Elway, trying to undo those three previous Super Bowl experiences that ended in defeat. The AFC has lost 13 consecutive times to the NFC, and the reason, perhaps, turnovers. NFC 44-10, the advantage there. Look at the bottom line. The average score the last 13 years, NFC 38, AFC 17. Oh, those turnovers.
Well, the turnovers, Dick, you know, those turnovers just didn't happen. They were caused by the NFC. They've been bigger, stronger, and more physical. They have just out-hit the AFC. That's the reason why they've won 13 in a row.
And the Green Bay Packers this week working hard in their practice sessions. What did you learn from that?
Well, you learned a lot. The one reason, you got to give some hope to Denver today. Everybody thinks it's going to be Green Bay. Denver has hope because of John Elway. He's a better quarterback this time than he was in the previous three. He's making better decisions, a better offense. He gets to run for him. The offensive line has been terrific. They got Terrell Davis running the football. But the one weak point, their defense, it takes chances. It's risky. It could backfire on them today.
All right, all or nothing Denver defense. Green Bay, you usually talk about Favre. He's easy to talk about, a delightful talent. But the defense of the Packers, the last seven games, has allowed only seven touchdowns.
Well, Vince Lombardi would be very proud of this defensive football team. They're a stereotype NFC defense. They are the biggest front seven in the National Football League. In the defensive secondary, very physical guys. And at the line of scrimmage, they just want to beat you up. They want to control the line of scrimmage, and they do.
All right, we're set for the kickoff, but first the introduction of the starting lineup. So return to San Diego, California in a moment.
Come back to Southern California. Every kid who has ever worn a helmet dreams of this moment, the Super Bowl. Today, these are those kids in big bodies about to be introduced to live out those dreams.
Well, Dick, I had a chance to stand in that tunnel before the game, and I realized it was my greatest moment of my athletic life, standing in there, and I did realize, wow, your dream can come true.
Green Bay Packers will be introduced first. NFC champions, 13-3 this year, as they were a year ago.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Super Bowl 32.
Offensive starters. Frank Winters. At right guard from South Dakota State, number 63, Adam Timmerman. At right tackle from Texas A&I, number 72, Earl Dotson. At tight end from Boston College, number 89, Mark Chimura. At wide receiver from South Carolina, number 87, Robert Brooks. At running back from Georgia Tech, number 25, Dorsey Lovins. At fullback from North Carolina, number 30, William Henderson. At quarterback from Southern Mississippi, number 4, Brett Favre. Of the Packers, Mike Holmgren. Here you
go. Michael George Holmgren, the 11th Green Bay coach, his sixth year, was a backup quarterback at the University of Southern California. He, like Mike Shanahan, his counterpart, a former offensive coordinator with the San Francisco 49ers. Title town well represented here in San Diego. The appearance of the Denver Broncos. Bill Romanowski is out first for Denver. Denver, 12-4. If you're superstitious, they're wearing the blue uniforms, the home uniforms. They were undefeated this year, 9-0. Neil Smith, you were talking to him the other day about this experience, this very moment.
Well, he was asking me on Tuesday about what's it like before you get introduced. I'm telling him how good it is. Neil Smith got so excited. He had goosebumps so big on his arms. He says, no more. And he took off running. Neil Smith, it's a great moment for you.
And now, the American Football Conference champion, Denver Broncos. Meet the Broncos offensive starters. At wide receiver from Missouri Southern, number 80, Rod Smith. At left tackle from Oregon, number 65, Gary Zimmerman. At left guard from Idaho, number 69, Mark Lorenz. Center from Boston College, number 66, Tom Nayland. At right guard from Washington, number 75, Brian Habib. At right tackle from Western Carolina, number 77, Tony Jones. Tight end from Savannah State, number 84, Shannon Sharp. And wide receiver from Stanford, number 87, Ed McCaffrey. And running back from Georgia, number 30, Terrell Davis. Fullback from Illinois, number 29, Howard Griffith. At quarterback from Stanford, number 7, John Elway. And the head coach of the Broncos, Mike Shanahan.
Mike Shanahan and his team on the field. Lucky number 7, unlucky 13. Will the luck be with 7 as he tries to break the AFC's 13 straight Super Bowl defeats? Back at Super Bowl 32, part of the ceremony, the flyover, the famed B-2A stealth bomber from Whiteman Air Force Base in Missouri. A lot of next training to get a shot, including that of Brett Favre. The first 11 Super Bowls, the referee tossed the coin. The first honorary coin toss was Super Bowl 12, a man back in the 1920s credited with really the popularity of the professional game, Harold Redgrange, the Galloping Ghost, with the honors.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming to midfield for the coin toss are Packer captains Travis Jervey, Lamont Hollenquist, Dorsey Levens, Brett Favre, Leroy Butler, and Reggie White. Representing the Broncos are captains Dwayne Carswell, Bill Romanowski, Steve Atwater, Terrell Davis, and John Elway. Joining us for the coin toss ceremony, our former Washington Redskins coach Joe Gibbs, San Diego Doug Williams, and Doug's coach from Grambling State University, the winningest coach in college football history, Eddie Robinson. The referee for today's game is Ed Hockley. To toss the coin, Hall of Famer Joe Gibbs.
Gentlemen, why don't you come together and please shake hands. Good afternoon, everyone. This is the commemorative coin for Super Bowl 32. This is heads, this is tails. Heads and tails. Joe, will you please come forward and toss the coin? Captain White, please call the toss. Call it while it's in the air. He's called tails. It is tails. Green Bay has won the toss. Do you wish to accept, receive, or defend a goal? Receive, which goal? Let's change around then. Please put your backs to the goals you'll be defending. Green Bay has won the toss and will receive. Good luck, man.
47-year-old Ed Hockley, today's game referee, with us on the Denver sidelines, Jim Gray.
All right, thank you, Dick. Well, Mike Shanahan kept it very simple for his troops before the game. He told them there are four keys. He said, guys, we can't get into third and long situations. We can't turn the ball over. The AFC has had 44 turnovers in the last 13 Super Bowls. They've lost all 13. He went on to say, hey, guys, we gotta watch the first 25 plays because if they get out in front of us and come after us early, that could be the difference. If we're 14 to 21 points behind, we won't catch up. Now as for John Elway, I spoke to him. John told me the following. He just wants to slow things down. He said, right now, things are going 800 miles per hour. If I slow down, I'll be much more effective. With the Packers today is John Docker.
And they're going to do it with the three wide receiver set. We'll see Derek Mays a lot. Coaches told me it's simple. Our third wide receiver is better than their fifth defensive back, and we expect Mays to make some big plays. All the more so because Antonio Freeman was recovering from the flu this week. He didn't practice on Thursday. Light workout Friday and Saturday. And he told me before the game he's fine. He slept well and he hydrated himself, but who knows how long he'll be able to play. And Dick, as we approach the kickoff, the Packers are poised and pumped to repeat.
All right, thank you, John Dockery. Jason Elam, who played his college football at the University of Hawaii, will kick it off. Antonio Freeman, who led the Packers with 81 catches during the regular season, and Aaron Hayden, our deep. Hayden, a former San Diego Charger, very familiar with these environs, and the dream of Super Bowl 32 begins with a short kick to the 5. Freeman skips to the 24 and is crushed under a wave of Bronco tacklers there. On the field comes Brett Favre, the league's most valuable player for the third consecutive year, shared with the Lions' Barry Sanders. The men who will protect him are Verba, Taylor, Winters, Timmerman, and Dotson up front. In the backfield, Dorsey Levin's fourth in the league in rushing. Henderson is the blocker, Freeman the leading receiver. Brooks back from an injury a year ago, and Pro Bowl tight end Mark Shimura from the 24. Dorsey Levin's finds a crease, but it closes in a hurry. Tyrone Braxton up to make the tackle from the secondary. Gain of maybe a yard, the defensive alignment for the Denver Broncos. A 4-3, Neil Smith and Alfred Williams on the outside, Traylor and Tanuvasa are the inside tackles. Mobley, a good young linebacker, Aldridge, Romanowski, the veteran. The linebacking core with Crockett and Gordon at the corners. Steve Atwater and Tyrone Braxton, the safeties. Second down, 9, and Brett Favre to throw. Under pressure, he's hit, stays on his feet, still gets the ball away, but he was not out of the pocket. No flag goes down. Favre did not get outside the pocket, and yet there was no flag. And here's Phil Simms accounting.
Well, there was a receiver out in the flat for Brett Favre. He was covered, so Brett Favre did the smart thing. He threw it over his head. That's the reason why it was not called a penalty.
Mike Shanahan thought he should have gotten the call.
Mobley coming on the blitz, untouched. His speed makes it happen.
Well, it gives you an idea how strong Favre is. Smith is there, Mobley is there, and Favre does the smart thing. He throws the ball away. Just remember, Dick, there's no such thing as in the grasp anymore.
Boy, he did a great job of loading three on charging Broncos. 3rd and 9, another blitz. Favre throws downfield, complete. First down at the 37 to Freeman. Steve Atwater makes a hit, and as he has done so many times the last 3 years, Favre on 3rd and long produces.
Well, he does the hardest thing that there is to do in the Super Bowl, to hit that first pass down the field. Antonio Freeman wide open, a blitz by the Denver Broncos. They take a chance. Brett Favre stands in there, makes a good throw down the field.
Freeman doing a good job of holding onto the football on a vicious hit by the safety Atwater. First down at the Packer 38, a 13-yard throw. Levin's big ball. Levin's bolts his way to midfield. 13 more for Levin's.
I'll tell you, Verba and Taylor, 78 and 73, and Frank Winter in the center. Look at the blocking, man on man up front, and that's all they really want is man on man blocking, and the hole was there.
The one thing the Green Bay Packers are going to do today, wherever that safety comes up to the right, they're going to run the ball left. If he comes left, they'll run right. They will not run at the extra defensive back.
Levin's again runs left. That's a hole. 5 yards, 10 yards, 12, and another first down. Darian Gordon from the secondary makes the tackle.
This is a classic example of what you just talked about. Atwater came up on the left-hand side, the right-hand side of the offense, and you'll see Atwater is down. He's right not in the picture right now, but when they see him up, see Atwater there? Now look how far he has to go to make the tackle, Phil. All the way across the field, they ran away from him.
The worst rushing defenses, Super Bowls, Denver Broncos. The others that had the worst record stopping the run all lost, Miami, Denver, and Minnesota. Levin's, this time the defense of the Broncos, a little tougher. Alan Aldridge makes the stop.
Well, Green Bay for offensive game plan, very simple. They got to handle the blitz and try to overpower the smaller defense, which they've been doing.
Well, we've seen both, Paul. They handle the blitz. Denver's defense, what they want to do is stop the short passing game of the Green Bay Packers, because what they do, they catch those short passes and they take off and get those long runs. I thought they would come out and be very conservative on defense. Took a couple chances early, got burned.
You saw Mike Holmgren looking at his card. Each team, each coach scripts the first 15 plays. Throwing on the run, and what a throw and catch to Freeman. And another Green Bay first down at the 22. Gordon the tackler. They're on 13. Boy, that is the number. Another 13-yard gain.
This is made by Brett Favre. He gets to throws the ball to the outside. It's a blitz. People coming in. Antonio Freeman, what he did there was excellent. Took his time, got some separation from the defensive back. But watch Brett Favre. He throws through the defender. Somebody jumps. He drops his arm down to the side, finds that open hole, and throws the ball in it.
Incredibly, 13 yards. Three times on this opening series, they've gained 13 as the NFC celebrates 13 in a row. The throw to Freeman. Is he in the end zone? Touchdown!
Antonio Freeman. They connected for 81 yards, a Super Bowl record a year ago. They strike early in Super Bowl 32.
When you take a look at Antonio Freeman here, here's the ball. Look at his feet. Are they both down? They are both down. The official is right on it. Perfect call.
Ryan Longwell. Tough hold there, but he gets the ball down and hits 7-0. Boy, Favre, what a job on the throw as he was being thrown backwards. Finds Freeman for the score. 22 yards, and the Packers are in the lead. 4 minutes and 2 seconds. The Packers go 76 yards and 8 plays. Favre to Freeman, 22 yards for the touchdown. And the Broncos, who came close to stopping Favre early in that series, and then he broke loose on a series of 13-yard plays before the 22-yard score. Von Hebron is deep as John Elway awaits his opportunity. And the kickoff by Longwell. Von Hebron, the smallest man of the Broncos at 5'8". Finds a little hole, 30. And Hebron out to the 38-yard line and the 40. And 42 as he burrows his way, a terrific return. Elway will be on the field.
Expect short routes. The blitz, Antonio Freeman, no short route, runs deep. Watch Tyrone Braxton. He's expecting the route to be changed. A quick look in, a quick out. He stutters, it's too late. Brett Favre anticipates, throws it back to the end zone. Touchdown, great game planning by the Green Bay Packers.
And now the 37-year-old John Elway from his own 42. Terrell Davis, the San Diego native. And Davis across the 45, a gain of 4. Doug Evans and Eugene Robinson in the secondary for Green Bay make the tackle. The Broncos offensively, of course, their leader Elway. No man in the history of the league has won more games regular season than John Elway. Zimmerman, Schlereth, Nalen going to the Pro Bowl, Habib and Jones, the lightest offensive line in the NFL. The backfield of Terrell Davis second to Barry Sanders in rushing, Griffith the blocker, Rod Smith and McCaffrey are the wide receivers. Shannon Sharp caught more passes than any tight end in the league this year. Second and 6. Davis straight ahead close to the 50 where he's tackled by Reggie White and Santana Dotson. Reggie White on his way to his 12th consecutive Pro Bowl. He with Dotson, Gilbert Brown, the huge one, and Gabe Wilkins, the front four of Green Bay. The linebackers, Seth Joyner, the former Eagle, Bernardo Harris, and Brian Williams. The back four, Tyrone Williams and Doug Evans, and those two safeties, veterans, Eugene Robinson and Leroy Butler, as good as any pair in the league. Third and 2. Eugene Robinson made the hit.
What a nice play by Terrell Davis. Now John Elway's looking downfield. He doesn't see anybody right away, but Terrell Davis, nobody really covers him when he comes out of the backfield. And what you have to watch about Terrell Davis, watch after he catches the ball. He sees the first down marker. He knows he's got to get to it. He just goes upfield. Eugene Robinson can't stop him.
Good first play for the Denver Broncos. John Elway, that first throw's the hardest. They know it. They call that play right from the start. It's drop back, throw Terrell.
Happy man is Davis, who played at Georgia after first beginning his career at Cal State Long Beach. Elway under pressure, scrambles, throws to the sideline, incomplete, intended for Davis again.
Well, the Denver offense today, they would love to run Terrell Davis, make Green Bay play him on us, because if you do that, they feel like they can get some good matchups, run some play action passes, and go down the field and get those big plays.
It's simply for the Green Bay Packer defense, it's just this. They got to get a better pass rush. If there is a weakness on Green Bay's team, it's their pass rush. That time, Elway, you saw him get out to the outside. They have to get a better rush.
So second and 10. All four plays have gone to Terrell Davis on Denver's first possession. Under pressure, they smack it down. Gilbert Brown, the grave digger, the big defensive tackle in on the play.
Well, Gilbert Brown, he's not going to, like, shake you at the line of scrimmage and run around you, but what he can do, number 93 makes a good move, comes in on Mark Schlereth, just keeps pushing the pocket, and that's the quarterback's worst enemy, is a defensive lineman getting upfield and getting in your face and knocking the ball down.
Well, Schlereth actually does the right thing. He sits there, he waits, and Brown comes into his area. He went to block him, and I said went to.
Yeah.
Gilbert Brown, most of his plays come early in games, not late. He's been injured much of the year. So third and 10 for Elway. Throws underneath, incomplete, and the flag flies. Darren Sharper may have been there too soon. Or was it Doug Evans?
Well, McCaffrey just got thrown to the ground. Whether it's holding, it's not pass interference, it's holding. They throw McCaffrey on the ground, and it's a 5-yard penalty, but it is a first down.
Automatic first down.
One thing that Denver really...
Before the pass was thrown, holding by the defense, number 33, 5-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Doug Evans, and it's going to be on McCaffrey. Look at this.
Now, well, Ed McCaffrey, what happened? He got Doug Evans thinking inside, inside, and then when he broke back outside, Doug Evans was fooled. He puts his hands out and tackles him.
So the third and 10, a 5-yard penalty gives Denver the first down at the 41. Green Bay 7, Denver nothing. Terrell Davis skipping outside. He's to the 20, he's to the 14-yard line. 27 yards for Terrell Davis.
Paul, I don't know how many times you've said it. Great runners have one good thing. They have patience, and they set the blocks up. Terrell Davis inside, goes inside again, back outside for the third time. That creates the big hole for him to run into.
Well, Howard Griffiths gets an outstanding block on Brian Williams, number 51, and enables Terrell Davis to get the outside. But the one thing I was going to talk about, Shanahan told us, Dick, just be patient. This is a long football game. Be very patient with your offense and defense.
Davis again. Stop, starts, makes something out of nothing, gets a couple of yards before Leroy Butler makes the tackle. Now, Terrell Davis, we were kidding during the championship game. He says, I take a hot bath every Saturday night. That's my superstition. And we kind of stretched it a bit and said, well, he takes a bubble bath. He said he's been getting all kinds of free gifts from ladies around the country, some free bubble bath.
Yeah.
He said, please don't do that. He said, I got 15 different kind of bubble bath. But he's changed now. You know what he's taking a bath in now?
Money.
Hundreds.
Hundreds.
He said,
yeah.
Send hundreds. I'm going to take a bath in $100 bill.
He's just kidding, of course.
Second down and 8 as Heppern replaces Davis. Elway scrambles. Going left. 10, 5, Elway to the 2. The old man who has scrambled well through his career, in fact, has rushed the ball more than any quarterback in NFL history, almost 740 times.
Well, John Elway, great protection by the offensive line. This is what they don't want. Green Bay doesn't want. Don't create these big lanes where he can step up, throw the ball, or run for those vital first downs.
You see Von Heber, number 22, the back. He goes out in the pass pattern. He doesn't do anything. So what does he do? He goes back and he blocks Bernardo Harris.
First and goal from the 2. Denver trying to tie it. 10-yard rush for Elway. To the goal line. No signal yet. Stuff right at that heavy line. He has to at least penetrate, just touch the nose to the front edge of that line, and did not.
You know, when a situation like this, Phil, when you're going to see Heppern here, when he dives, maybe in a situation, you got Griffith blocking in front, if he can keep his body while he was going down, he was caught from behind. But that looked awfully close.
Well, Elway thought so. That much. Second and goal. 10th play of the drive. Terrell Davis is back in.
Denver Broncos all week long, they've been hearing about how little their offensive line is and how big Green Bay's defensive line is. Well, I think we just saw that this line is quick, it has good size, and it's physical, and it did a terrific job on that drive.
And Davis has scored 15 rushing touchdowns in the regular season, has won in the Super Bowl, a 10-play drive, and took him 58 yards. Elam's try for point, and the game is tied at 7. The mile-high salute. Terrell Davis has the whole state of Colorado doing this, 7-all. Sends it toward the white jersey Packers, Antonio Freeman at the 6. Wow, what a shot into that wedge, and Freeman hit at the 22. Derek Lovell made the tackle, and that special teams of the Broncos are fired.
17-yard return.
Gil Brandt are chatting online about the game. That's Superbowl.com. Reverse to Robert Brooks, has a blocker. 7-yard line, a gain of about 5. Ray Crockett and Maa Tanuvasa make the tackle.
Well, one of the reasons you come out and you run a reverse is you want to slow the defense down. The first drive, they saw Denver's defense. It was fast. It was over pursuing. So you run this. You hope to get some yards. You hope for a big play. But the main thing is you want to make that defense play honest for the rest of the game.
And Derek Mays did a great job by not blocking in the back. He just got out of the way.
Favre 3 for 4 in the opening drive. Freeman 3 of those catches for 48 yards and the 22-yard touchdown. Fake to Dorsey Lemons, throw downfield, intercepted by Tyrone Braxton, and Denver has it at the 43-yard line.
The reason for the interception, the Denver Broncos come on a blitz. Brett Favre knows it cannot be picked up. Watch the corner come in. On the blitz, Brett Favre is going to move away from him. He goes to his right. He knows he has to get rid of it. The receiver is not open, causes the overthrow.
You saw Mike Holmgren arguing he thought that the receiver, Robert Brooks, was held by Ray Crockett. Ray Crockett grabbed his arm, but the ball was not catchable where it was thrown.
The first drive, the Denver Broncos blitzed 3 times. They were never picked up on any of the blitzes. Brett Favre made the plays. That time he just didn't.
From the 45, so the Broncos get the first turnover. That's atypical in play in the Super Bowl. And Terrell Davis ripping his way to the 29-yard line.
You know, Dick, all year long we're talking about Terrell Davis, and as Gibbs is the line coach, works with him also, and the offensive line say he only makes one cut, and once he makes that cut, he makes his decision to go. Watch the move.
Yeah, and Paul, this is the play Green Bay knows they have to stop. It's the cutback. Even though it's the pitch, you think it's sweep right. Terrell takes it outside, always cuts backside. The backside of the defense has got to hustle, come down the line of scrimmage, and stop that play.
16 yards for Davis. He's gained 54 yards in this opening quarter. Goes down Elway, lots of time. Throws underneath, complete to Shannon Sharp. And Sharp near a first down at the 20.
This whole thing is the patience of John Elway. The offensive line blocking and Elway being patient.
Yeah, it's Elway being patient, but the offensive line, what a job they do, because this is supposed to be a quick throw. He's open. He fakes. He sees John Elway move. The offensive line keeps him out. It enables Shannon Sharp to come all the way across the formation and get open.
Well, you got a linebacker, Bernardo Harris, is trying to cover him, number 50, 55, and that didn't happen.
Sharp caught 72 passes in the regular season to lead Denver. And Davis on 2nd and 1 easily picks up the first down at the Packard 17. Santana Dotson made the stop.
You know, Dick, all week long and all year long, this offensive line of the Denver Broncos, everybody said how small they are. They can't do this. They can't do that. You know, they went away to Kansas City and also to Pittsburgh only one time, and they had to do it on a silent count. Only one time did they have illegal motion. This team is together. Those 5 guys are together.
And they got tired of hearing it. Mike Shanahan even said to us with a laugh, he has been walking by them all week and going, hey, this is my tiny little group over here. Giving them the business. You know, it had to fire them up a little, make them come out strong early.
First down. It's Howard Griffith, a rare call for the man they call the human plow, because he blocks for Terrell Davis, but Griffith trying to cross up the Packers has a couple. Now, we talked about the weight distribution. The Broncos, well, in football terms, that's light. 289-pound average, lightest in the NFL. The Packers defensive line, that's very heavy for a front 4.
Yes, it is. And of course, what really offsets it, Gilbert Brown, the nose guard, 345.
Well, you know, Paul, you sat next to him. I think he might be just a couple over.
I'll tell you, if he's closer to 370, that might be a 100-pound difference between Nalen and Brown. Flag down, free play for Denver as Terrell Davis is whacked at the 11-yard line. And George Kuntz in on that tackle.
Something we don't see enough from NFL quarterbacks, the snap count. We got two today that use it very well. They go quick, they go long. They use it in situations that really give their team an advantage. John Elway did it that time.
Offsides by the defense, number 90. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Darius Holland lined up at the defensive right end position, lurched offside.
You'll see him right at the bottom of the screen. You know the other thing that Elway told us? He said, what is it, Dick, the first time in 3 weeks and two games back. Yeah. He said, I've been able to use a snap count. Yeah. Doing silent count for two games.
Yeah, all week long, he says he'd get in the huddle and go silent. He goes, no, I don't have to do that this week. I can actually call signals and play a normal game.
Just under 2 minutes remaining in the opening quarter. Green Bay scored first. Denver after the interception trying to take the lead. Second and short. Davis. Davis to the 6-yard line and a first down as Eugene Robinson, the veteran from Colgate, came up from a safety position to make the hit. Both these quarterbacks grew up in a football family. Both their fathers coaches, and Terrell Davis slow getting up.
Watch 71. Watch his right leg. Santana Dotson is going to trip him. He sticks his leg out and trips him right here. And I think Terrell Davis just falls on the ball because he got up, walked off the field. He was fine.
Well, for a report, let's go to Jim Gray.
All right. Thank you very much, Dick. Well, Terrell Davis had the bad ribs. He's not wearing the flak jacket, but it's not his ribs. He was kicked in the head, hurt his head. He's a little dizzy, but he will return. Dick?
All right. Thank you, Jim. A big, productive first quarter for Davis. First and goal from the 5. For a couple to the 3-yard line. Santana Dotson, named after the Native American chief Santana, and his dad Alphonse, who played in the National Football League, in fact was drafted by Green Bay in 1965. Terrell Davis back in.
This could be one of those scenarios. You know, you look at these teams, and Green Bay's watched Denver for 2 weeks on film, and they say, okay, we see the running game, we see the running game, and we think we can stop it, but when you see it in person, it's a lot different.
Davis, stop, second charge, gains a yard, and Dotson there to plug the hole. It'll be third and goal from the 2 with 31 seconds now remaining in the opening quarter.
Denver doesn't have to take a play. Dick, the play clock is going to run out before the scoreboard clock will run out before the play clock. They'll just go to the second quarter.
And Mike Shanahan very pleased that the first drive took over 5 minutes for a touchdown, with the interception consuming more time. Each team with only 2 possessions in the opening 15 minutes. Final seconds tick away. Favre against Elway. 7-7. Third and goal. So what's the call, quarterback Sims?
Well, I would think the discussion on the sideline had to be, all right, if we run the football and we get hats inside the 1-yard line, are we going to do that for the reason we're going to try it again on fourth down? So I think that would determine what they would do in this situation.
If they throw the ball incomplete, they're going to kick,
the field goal.
Terrell Davis, the deep back. Green Bay has not allowed a touchdown pass in 32 quarters. Play action wide open. Elway walks it in for the score.
Tells you what Green Bay's defense was thinking. They were thinking, this team is running the ball, they're going to run it again in this situation, and they are completely fooled by the play fake of John Elway.
He could have thrown it to Griffith if he wanted to, but he just walked it into
the
zone.
He did the smart thing.
Yeah, keep it.
Make sure if you throw it. I've seen them drop those type of passes.
Tom Rolando for Elam, and Elam adds the extra point. So after Tyrone Braxton's doing some heavy talking along the sidelines to his defensive teammates. Meanwhile, Tyrone Braxton, who has 35 career interceptions, tied for the club lead with 4 this year. His pick sets up the Denver score, 14-7. Elam sends it short this time to Freeman at the 8. And tackled as he crosses the 25-yard line.
Well, you got to have discipline down on the goal line. You got to make sure you cover both plays. Bernardo Harris, the linebacker, goes inside because the tight end, Shannon Sharp, blocks down, and now there's nobody on the outside for containment. John Elway's able to come out. Leroy Butler, hey, that's not his job. He's supposed to cover Shannon Sharp.
And you know, Bernardo Harris, Phil, what he's got to do is he went right down after Terrell Davis and forgot about everything else. There's the guy that made the interception. Yes, sir.
Played at Little North Dakota State, the Bison. Hell, not so though. They were a three-time National Division II champs. From the 28, Favre to the left, tip the backfield, and then the crowd develops and pushes him back to the 25, led by Alfred Williams and Tyrone Braxton.
Well, Alfred Williams, Dick, told us when he came in the meeting, all smiles, which he always does. He said, I'm not going to talk in this ball game. I didn't talk all week. I talked all year. I've got the biggest mouth going.
And that's going to be some accomplishment for him, not to talk during this game. Not, hey, he's a funny guy, and he is a great talker.
He is, and he's a great
player.
He has
the greatest laugh maybe in the league.
Yeah.
Big baritone laugh and likes to use it. No gain on first down for Green Bay. Tight end Jeff Thomason in motion. Favre underneath, complete to Chimura, one of his close friends, one of the three amigos, along with Frank Winters, Aldridge and Braxton, collaborate on the tackle, a gain of about five. Chimura played at Boston College for Tom Coughlin, Jacksonville head coach. Last drive was their first NFC turnover. NFC now in the Super Bowl in nearly four full games. So while the NFC has played clean in that regard, the AFC's been coughing it up. Will that be an omen for the long-suffering American Football Conference fans? Third down, five. Blitz. Atwater makes the hit. Is it a fumble? If it is, it's Denver's ball. It is.
Green Bay has not picked up a blitz yet by the Denver Broncos. They're in four wide receivers. They have five guys across the line. There are six blitzers. They cannot pick them all up. Steve Atwater comes in the gap. He's free. Brett Favre changed the play, but he still didn't have enough people to pick up all the blitzers.
Look at Brett Favre. His back is to Atwater. He doesn't even see Atwater. He never reads him right from the beginning of the play. Neil Smith gets the ball.
And a good job by Neil Smith. Just cover the ball. Don't take a chance by picking it up and maybe fumbling like Green Bay picking it back up.
So two Packer turnovers, and it's Denver's ball at the 33. Hebron, not Terrell Davis in the backfield. Elway, ton of time. Man open, incomplete. Hebron, the halfback, and slipped deep.
Well, he wasn't open, Dick, really. Seth Joyner, a really cagey linebacker, been around a long time. He saw the play action fake inside. He just stayed back. And in fact, if John Elway throws it to the receiver that time, Seth Joyner's going to pick it off. Look to your left or to the bottom of the screen. You're going to see Seth Joyner off to the fumble. Steve Atwater just coming in free again. Every time they blitz, nobody has picked up that extra blitzer. That causes the fumble.
Hebron still in, so Davis resting on the sidelines. Hebron leading 14-7, second and 10. And nothing there. Big Gilbert Brown losing his helmet in the process of helping on the tackle. Bernardo Harris there first.
Doesn't make any difference. With or without a helmet, Gilbert's going to play. His mother told him, quit limping out there, just play football. He loses his helmet on this play. There's Gilbert Brown, 93. Watch this. Nailing this on him. He got his hand up in his face. Watch his helmet come up. That is what you call putting hands to the face.
Tom Nalen had a chance to block him last year, and he says, well, okay, I'm going to block this guy. They played up in Green Bay. He's probably just another one of these big fat guys. He says, the first time I hit him, I went, wow, he is strong. So he learned quick that Gilbert Brown is a good athlete.
So third down and 10, Elway shotgun for the first time. He goes long for Rod Smith. Incomplete, broken up by Tyrone Williams. So an interesting choice for Shanahan. Does he try a long field goal?
They will.
Yes.
Well, this time, John Elway, what happens? Rod Smith, good job. A little hesitation at the line of scrimmage. He is by Tyrell Williams. John Elway waits too long, and then he underthrows the pass.
That forces a long field goal attempt of 51 yards by Jason Elam, his longest this year, 53. But if you look at the Green Bay Packers, all 11 men are up on the line of scrimmage. If he misses, Green Bay gets it at the 41. It's high enough. Is it long enough? Yes! You know, this is really the line blocking, but it's a three-man thing. It's the center, the holder, and the kicker, and he had, Elam had enough time, and look, he gets the ball up quicker than anyone I've seen in a long time. Stated Badwater forces the fumble. Denver 17-7. And welcome back, 17-7 Denver at the 10 as Antonio Freeman. And he's picked up at the 22-yard line by Dedrick Dodge, who has a Super Bowl ring with the San Francisco 49ers. Played at Florida State. John Elway saying Jason Elam kicked the second longest field goal in Super Bowl history, 51 yards. Steve Christie's 54-yarder in 94, the longest, the Buffalo kicker.
John doesn't get real excited because he knows he's got a lot of work to do yet.
Well, I think he just expected Jason to make that. He says, okay, he did what he's supposed to. Let's don't get too excited.
Favre with a fumble and an interception. That breaks a string. The last three Super Bowls, the NFC had 10 turnovers to zero for the AFC teams. For five for six before Braxton and company can wrestle him down.
This is what you'd expect the Green Bay Packers offense to do. Come out, try to settle down, and just come straight off the blocks, come straight ahead, use some power. Good block by William Henderson, the fullback, and let their big runner be powerful. This way, you keep that defense of Denver's a little honest, and you can don't have to worry about those blitzes.
Well, as the NFC has dominated, no turnovers by the AFC to 10 for the NFC the last three. But Denver starting out with two, a fumble and an interception. Clemens picking his way to the 31, 32, just short of the first down. It'll be third and one.
Isn't that what Holmgren told us, though, the other day? Dick, we sat there talking to him, and he says, what we have to do, my job really is to calm these guys down. Just be patient. Just wait. Because all the things that we've done all year long will work if we're patient enough to do them.
He wasn't calm when we saw him back in August when they played up in Toronto in the preseason, was he?
I never seen anybody in the He said, you know, I think I'm driving him nuts. I think I'm driving him crazy.
You know what? He did.
Yeah,
he was. All the players were complaining, you know, coach is crazy.
Well, he did not want his Green Bay Packers to be complacent after winning the Super Bowl, and he took it out hardest on his assistant coaches.
You know, great. Dick, that's what he said. I drove my coaches harder this year to make sure we gave our players a chance to repeat. Let's don't get beat because the coaches have a lack of preparation. They accomplished that all year long. The record, the way they play, it shows they're very prepared.
What a coaching start for him in high school in San Francisco. His first 3 years, his teams were 0-22. That start all the way to a Super Bowl ring as a head coach in Green Bay.
Yeah, but he reminded you right off the bat, I wasn't the head coach.
No, just assistant. Well, that's important. You saw it's about a half yard shy of a first down. Third down. Central State of Oklahoma. He has been their best lineman all year.
Keith Traylor, what the Denver defense does, they rely on speed. They try to beat you to the point of attack. Number 94 just coming down the line of scrimmage. Dorsey Levens doesn't even have a chance to cut back. Keith Traylor, big and very athletic.
Craig Hendrick with the first punt of Super Bowl 32. Darian Gordon returned three for touchdowns during the season, waves off his teammates, and it's downed. A short kick just inside the Bronco 40 at the 39. 31-yard punt. So Denver has it back, leading by 10 with 10 minutes and change remaining in the half.
Welcome back to San Diego. I'm Jim Gray. Well, Terrell Davis was kicked in the head on that goal line situation a couple of series ago. He's been over on the bench after he returned into the game, taking oxygen for about the past 5 or 6 minutes. He's got the concussion and he should return. Right now, they're just being cautious. Dick?
All right, thank you, Jim. First down, Denver leading 17-7 with 10 minutes, 9 seconds remaining in the opening half. The underdog Broncos forging into a 10-point lead and have the ball back. First down, they're averaging over six a play in the game, throwing to Shannon Sharp and to the 45-yard line, a gain of six. Randy Cross is with us. Randy?
Thank you, Dick. You know, up until that last pass, Shannon Sharp was lined up on the right side the whole time. Denver's got the momentum. They've got the running game going on. But as you see, Shannon Sharp's pass routes come out here with one catch. He's only lining up on the right. When they're passing their best, he's all over the field. Back to you, Dick.
All right, Randy knows the Super Bowl feeling with the San Francisco 49ers. Shannon now with two catches for 15 yards, second and four Elway. Out of the backfield, complete to Sharp again. Little yardage, only a couple, well covered by Bernardo Harris, third year backer from North Carolina.
Well, what Shannon Sharp really does well, this is his favorite route, coming across the formations, trying to go underneath some of the coverage and hoping his guy, this time Bernardo Harris, hoping he gets in the way of another defensive player, creates the opening for him.
You gotta really like what the Denver Broncos are doing too, Dick. They're controlling the clock and the ball. You know, everything, don't drop passes, first downs. They were averaging 6.3 yards per play on first down.
You saw Sharp, the leading tight end receiver in the 90s in the NFL. Derek Lovell is the ball carrier, and he has the first down at the 50. So Lovell, who came up with a 100-yard game in reserve of Terrell Davis in that first playoff win for Denver against Jacksonville, he is now the tailback. It's interesting, Mike Shanahan, as he talked with us this week, that one of his pitches to his team was, you know, we win at Kansas City, a tough crowd. We win at Pittsburgh, and now we get to play Green Bay on a neutral field. Now, where do you think we've got our best chance?
Yes, it's a great psychological.
Illegal formation by the offense. Number 65, an ineligible number, was on the end of the line. It's a 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
So Gary Zimmerman uncovered, cost the Broncos 5 and cost them a first down.
Well, what happened? Ed McCaffrey, here's Gary Zimmerman. Ed McCaffrey is up on the top of the screen. He's off the line of scrimmage. He does not have the tackle covered. That is illegal.
So the penalty is called against Zimmerman, but the mistake was made not by him, but by his
wide receiver. You know what happens? When in doubt, just blame the lineman. So that's what happens.
That always works.
Yes.
So instead of first down, it's third and a long 6 for Elway. Hebron, his running back. Blitz. Throws to Hebron. Saves the first down with a good open field tackle. Williams from the University of Southern California.
Well, they got what they wanted. Denver wanted the blitz. They were expecting the blitz. They throw the pass. But the problem is Brian Williams, he's fast, he's big, comes out. He knows they have about 8 yards to go. He just makes a good sure tackle.
Now they come up with 4th and 1 and Tom Ruin's first punt. He's not kicked as well in the postseason as the regular season when he averaged over 43. Robert Brooks, after a devastating knee injury a year ago, returning and having a solid season for the Packers and being used in the playoffs in this situation, returning punts. Ruins kick very high, beautiful spiral. Brooks lets it go, takes a Denver bounce, and another one, and is down at the 3-yard line. Dedrick Dodge will mark it at the 4. 7:38 left in the opening half.
Have been a rookie mistake. Darren Sharper, watch 42. He thinks the ball is going to go into the end zone, but the ball hits and goes back. Look where he is, where the ball is. Now he sees it and stops. I mean, that could have been disastrous for Green Bay. You have to play heads up all the time.
Even if he saw it, don't get so close to the ball. You never know where it's going to bounce.
Denver with a 5-minute-plus possession advantage. As far from his end zone, looking in, throwing underneath, incomplete. No flag. As Henderson, the intended receiver, and veteran Bill Romanowski there to break it up.
The one thing this Denver defense, they have noticed Green Bay does most to most teams. They love to come out. They put a lot of receivers short. And when nobody's open, Brett Favre looks underneath for that open receiver. Denver always tries to cover those short underneath receivers because they play a lot of man-to-man coverage.
Romanowski, who has never missed a game in 10 years, 160 regular season, now his 19th playoff, 2 rings with the 49ers, his first 2 years in the league. John Ulysses Mobley, number 51, The brilliant young linebacker from Kutztown State makes the hit.
Watch the trainer Tanabasa. They do a deal inside, and Mobley is in the middle, 51. Watch, you see the two tackles curl inside? Bam! Here's Mobley. That's his job. Step up, make the play. No gain.
Paul, they're trying to create a hole for John Mobley to run through because he has the speed to get there. That time, Green Bay has nobody to block him because he made that move inside.
You see Mobley nearly doubling his tackles in his second year and led Denver with 162. Far from his end zone, throwing deep downfield. Complete. His tight end at the 35, Martin Shimura. At the 26-yard line is Shimura leaping high to spear that, and again Favre at his best on third and long.
Well, Mark Shimura is going up the seam. They're trying to hit him between two defenders. A very risky throw by Brett Favre. One-hand catch by Mark Shimura. He's pretty well covered. Bill Romanowski, the one mistake he makes, turn around, look for the ball, you'd have a chance to knock it down.
Favre with a big third down conversion on the opening possession. The flag down as Dorsey Evans grinds it out across the 40-yard line. May have had too many men on the field for the Broncos.
Well, they only have 12.
So that'll be declined. Green Bay taking Levin's solid run worth about 15.
Illegal substitution, 12 men on the field by the defense. The penalty is declined. The play results in a first down.
John Mobley is trying to get off the field before the ball is snapped, and you can see him coming off. He just never gets off.
So with 6 minutes and 13 seconds left in this opening half, you see Glenn Robinson, the defensive coordinator, upset by that call, but 15-yard gain by Levens anyway. From the 41. Levens. Solid gain out to the 48-yard line. It'll be second and three. Mike Lotish, the veteran tackle, makes the stop.
Well, good play by the Green Bay Packers this time. They kind of get the action. You think it's going to go left, and he cuts back. And what it does, it just kind of creates a little hole because that Denver defense, they like to slant right and left, try to cut back sometimes on it.
Breakthrough year for Levens, who matriculated at Notre Dame and then transferred to Georgia Tech. He was just a special teamer when he was picked in the fifth round back in 94, has developed into the fourth leading rusher in the league. 58 yards today. The throw to Brooks complete. And Brooks hit at the 50, trying to nose forward, close to a first down at the Denver 49. Aldridge and Crockett, the tacklers. Crockett, who will be a free agent at the end of this season. Played at Detroit for many years, came over to the Broncos in 94. He played his college ball at Baylor.
Well, we got a close situation here, Dick. Come up, Paul, hurry.
Nose of the ball.
Nose of the ball, they made it, right? Is that
yes,
what you're saying?
They
okay.
made it. Nose of the ball.
Let's
nose
see.
Of the ball.
It's half of the ball.
Well, the half a nose. It's a real big nose. It's a ball with a huge.
For those of you who don't watch us during the regular season, Paul is, in the history of the National Football League, by far from off the field, the best judge of whether on close calls a team has a first down or not. He's never missed.
And he does it with one eye. That's what's
right.
really impressive.
In one eye, Dick.
First down at the 49. Freeman in motion. Favre drilling that ball, just throwing on the run to the 45-yard line, a gain of four. Here's Randy.
Thank you, Dick. You know, so far this year, the three-time MVP Favre, he kills people with improvisational skill. That means getting all over the field in the pocket. Well, so far, Brett has only been in the pocket. Blitz or no blitz, this Denver defense is containing Brett Favre inside and not letting him get out where he can kill him. Back to you.
All right, Randy. Antonio Freeman with that catch at the 43-yard line. It's second down and four. Also a Favre fumble when hit by Steve Atwater in the mix. Denver leads 17-7. Closing in on 4 minutes remaining in the half. Favre underneath, completes to Henderson. And he's hit immediately by Bill Romanowski. And Henderson gets up slowly.
That time Brett Favre changes the play at the line of scrimmage. Bill Romanowski on Mark Shimura down the field. They let him go. Brett Favre, not patient enough, this time drops it off to William Henderson for the short game. If he'd stayed with the tight end, he had a big play.
That was an outstanding play by Romanowski. I mean, he lets him go, and he knows in the back of Henderson is his, so he goes up, takes him.
Third and two.
Freeman just as he was hit by Atwater. And Antonio Freeman has five catches in this first half. And every time he's caught the ball, he's been drilled and hangs on.
You know, Phil, we're looking at receivers. I mean, Antonio Freeman is catching everything out there. He is getting smacked. He's been hit by Atwater. He's been hit by everybody. And the guy holds on to the ball.
Freeman from Virginia Tech. This is the first drive. He had three catches. And eventually 22 yards for the Green Bay touchdown.
He's a big receiver. He plays tough. Paul, he does this every week, making those tough catches over the middle and outside.
Favre, it's deflected and almost intercepted as Derek Mays, the intended receiver, Ray Crockett made the defensive play. Green Bay fans looking for a penalty.
Well, Ray Crockett has Derek Mays man for man on the outside. Right away, Derek Mays does the wrong thing for the quarterback. He goes right to the sideline, gives Brett Favre nowhere to throw the football. He does try to come back underneath Ray Crockett to make the play, but there's no place to throw it.
And there's not going to be any flag, because it had been on Mays first for pushing off, and then they let Crockett push off afterwards.
2:40 left in the half. Second and 10. Down into the flat. Is Mark Chamura. And he's to the 21-yard line before tackled. Appears to be another first down, 11 on the play.
Boy, Chamura on this play here, they're just looking for Favre. He makes a fake, and they're looking downfield. Play action, boom, and Chamura is wide open on the outside. He just finds him. Nobody covered him.
Third catch for Chamura. 6'5 and 253.
Let me tell you, this guy, Dick, Brett Favre, and Frank Winters pick on him unmercifully. They always make fun of something he's doing.
And there's the two-minute warning. First half, 17-7. Terrell Davis of the sensational first quarter and then kicked in the helmet, suffered a mild concussion, hits for the locker room. 2 minutes to go from the 21. Favre on first down, looking deep. Favre on the middle. Against Robert Brooks, and that'll give Green Bay the ball very close to the goal line.
I'll tell you, the officials are talking this over. You know why? Because Crockett's feet get tied up inside. This may not be pass interference. They're telling Denver, back off. Let's talk about this thing, because one of the officials on the side didn't see anything happen. It was the one in the end zone that saw it.
Ed Hockley in the white hat is a trial lawyer, law firm in Phoenix, so he knows all about listening to the case.
The feet were inadvertently tangled, so there is no foul on the play. Second down.
That will make the folks in Titletown very happy.
Well, Ray Crockett is in good position to cover Robert Brooks on the outside. You can see it. Watch him come across the middle. A little holding. He has him. The feet, they get tangled. As Ed Hockley said, inadvertently, that is not a penalty.
This is not. Watch the feet. Don't look at anything else but the feet. He's not touching with any part of the body. They're just playing football. That is an outstanding call to see the officials overrule it.
If there was any foul, it was before he made his break holding on to the jersey. But that's become so commonplace, it's rarely called. Second down, 10 at the 21. Throw complete. It's to Terry Mickens, who had only one catch all year. So that just shows you the complete nature of the game planning by coaches. Here's someone you don't figure will be involved, and Mickens gets a chance. Crockett made the tackle.
Yeah, Mickens going back and saying, Mickens said, don't throw that one to me anymore. He almost got killed going in there.
Maybe that's why he only had one. Maybe it was the other time he caught that one, didn't return for a while. So timeout call with the ball at the 15-yard line. No, clock is running.
Brett Favre's going to let it run down, then call the timeout. Use up as much time as possible just so he doesn't leave it for Denver.
So long as you're going to call timeout, let's not give the other team a chance to get the ball should we score.
Well, it's third down, and you want to really make sure of this play.
And it is third down and four. Very important. 17-7. Green Bay letting about, 25, 30 seconds run off.
And very smart by Green Bay. Just in case you don't pick up the third down, you kick the field goal. Now you limit the chances somewhat of Denver by taking some of that time off the clock.
And really, a third down, Dick, you don't want to rush in. They want to come away with a score, what Phil was just talking about. So you've got to be very sure of the play you're going to call.
Oh, Favre comes out with four wides. And now Hockley, the referee, going to officially mark the ball. Well, Mickens and Freeman to the right. Mays and Brooks to the left. Levins the running back. They often like to run out of this formation. And do. Levins breaking tackles to the 10-yard line and has the first down.
Now they still have two timeouts remaining. He's going to take one now, Favre.
With 7 seconds left on the clock. 63 yards rushing in the half for Dorsey Levins.
Good changeup by the Green Bay Packers. 3rd and 4, 5. They've been getting hurt by the blitz this time. They have the trap right up the middle. And Dorsey Levins has to make a couple of those extra yards just to get the first down. But a good job by Green Bay on this drive of controlling situations. That's the reason why they moved it all the way down the field, not getting in those third longs where they can get hurt by a blitz.
And though with 57 seconds remaining in the second quarter, they still have one timeout. They can still run the ball now on this play. They can run it.
So mass substitutions by Mike Holmgren. That's countered by Shanahan on the near sidelines. It's officially the 11-yard line. That's only statistically official, although the ball is almost tickling the 10 because they could get a first down. 17-7, the Broncos. Green Bay trying to cut it to 3 at the half. Into the end zone, incomplete. From behind Robert Brooks.
You know, Phil, did Brooks run the wrong route? Because that ball, he was open.
Well, Brooks was open, or there was a spot in the middle of the field. Brett Favre saw it, but watch Robert Brooks at the top. Here's his route. Brett Favre sees the middle of the field wide open.
Here comes.
He's throwing to the open spot. But Robert Brooks, he's doing what he's supposed to, run to the outside. The defenders are there.
Jeff Thomason, a second tight end, enters for Green Bay. 16th play of the drive. Remember, this started back at the 5-yard line on the ruined punt. Flag down. And that's no play. False start, I believe, Jeff Thomason.
Number 83, he is another tight end in the game, and he's off the line of scrimmage. And again, once you get set, you can't move. This play was stopped before.
The ball was snapped. False start by the offense, number 89. It's a 5-yard penalty. It's still second down.
It's not 89, it's 83.
And that's Thomason.
Thomason is the guy. He's on the end of the line. You're going to see him right here. Watch him move forward. Watch. Boom. That's it. Romanowski calls it. Officials call it.
Well, it was a good thing. Denver comes with a blitz. Green Bay does not pick it up. It would have been a negative play for Green Bay that time.
Only the 4th penalty of the game, as you can see. So back to the 15-yard line. The ball is spotted with 54 seconds left in the half. Second down. Complete to the 6-yard line as Robert Brooks makes the catch. Ray Crockett, the defender. Third down.
Still plenty of time. In fact, now really take your time. You got a chance to maybe get a first down, but try to score it. If you don't, you leave no time for Denver to run a 2-minute offense at the end of the first half.
They're going to have to go to the 2-inch line to get a first down.
They brought in the Thomason again, the tight end, and took out Brooks.
23 seconds left. Favre throwing to the end zone. Touchdown! A leaping catch by Mark Tremonti. The Amigos have struck with 12 seconds left in the half. Perfectly thrown ball by Favre. He just parachuted that over the defender and into the arms of the tight end. Ryan Longwell, the rookie from California, adds the extra point. 95 yards and 17 plays. It took a half of the quarter, 7 minutes, 26 seconds, and the payoff 6 yards far to Chimura.
Green Bay, good deception. What they do, they condense the formation. They put Robert Brooks in motion. Watch the tight end Chimura come out, get in the back of the end zone. Denver does not adjust well. Brett Favre, such a strong arm, but this is why he's the MVP three straight years, able to make that wonderful touch throw right over the top of Tyrone Braxton for the touchdown.
Well, you look at Braxton now. When Braxton's back, he goes up in the air, but he doesn't get enough depth. He has to get back. He sees Chimura going behind him. You've just got to run to the offensive receiver.
But we're talking about a manicure difference between knocking that one away and a touchdown. So Chimura with a touchdown, 17-14, in just seconds for this kick. Undoubtedly, he'll just be scooted down by Longwell, not allowing a return. He lines it into the wedge, speared by Byron Chamberlain, or it's Keith Burns, rather, the linebacker, and he returns to the 41-yard line. Clock stopped on change of possession, 6 seconds. Mr. MVP Favre on that scoring drive, 9 of 13, 74 yards, very patiently taking his team down the field. He's 13 for 19 and a half. 2 touchdowns, 1 interception. It appears Elway is going to take the kneel down, and that'll be it for the half. And so, one of the more interesting first halves in a long, long time, Super Bowls. 17-14. Green Bay struck first. 17 unanswered points by the Denver Broncos. 2 turnovers, Favre, an interception, and a fumble. And then Favre taking his team 95 yards to make it close. 17-14. Welcome back to San Diego. Ready for the second half. Denver will get it first, leading 17-14. Mark Chimura. Remember this play from the 5-yard line, the start of the 95-yard. It was 3rd and 10. He makes this catch in traffic. Seemed insignificant then, just a first down. But how crucial it was, and the payoff came at the end of that drive, 95 yards. 3rd down again. What a throw by Favre. Drops it in there to Chimura for the touchdown.
Well, Denver has the perfect defense on, really, in both situations. Mark Chimura just makes a great play the first time with the catch, and the second one, terrific throw by Brett Favre.
Any surprises, Paul? Defensively, I think for Denver and both Green Bay, I think, you know, Elway's really not thrown a lot of yardage. The defenses are playing, I think, a pretty good game.
Terrell Davis, it'll be a critical whether Davis there is Vaughn Hebron to return the kickoff. Whether Davis will return after a big opening quarter when he rushed for over 60 yards, 64 to be exact. Short kick to the sidelines to Hebron at the 10. Running behind the wedge and gets in trouble as he crosses the 21 and tackled at the 22. Let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Dick. I spoke to Mike Shanahan as he came out of the locker room. He said Terrell Davis will play in the second half. Then I had Terrell Davis come by as he was running out. He said he felt much better here. He got some treatment at halftime. He's going to try and play in the second half and feels he can be effective. Dick?
Well, you can see the importance of this man to the Denver offense. Gained 1,750 yards, just 10 yards shy of a mile in the regular season. And had the big opening quarter, then on the sideline, second period. Elway starts from the 23. And it's Davis. You can just see the power, and he fumbled the ball. And a scramble. Who's got it? Green Bay says they do. And that is the call. Packers ball. The first turnover by the Broncos on the first play of the second half. Davis doesn't fumble often.
Well, he doesn't, and they run their favorite running play. It's a pitch to Terrell Davis left. He's been sitting down on the bench for a long time. What happens? Green Bay comes in. They reach in, pull the ball away from him.
Brian Williams, actually, his arm, look at number 51. His arm comes back and hits the ball. That started the fumble of Terrell.
Yeah, Leroy Butler was in there as well. Tyrone Williams recovered the ball. First down at the 26. Packers hand off to Lemons. Lemons, oh, he almost lost it and was able to reclutch at the 26-yard line. Tackled by Mobley and Aldridge.
Well, we talked about the defenses and the way they're firing off the ball. Both defenses are playing extremely well. Look at how far upfield they're getting. And right there, you see Mobley just grabs onto Levins and Fink brings him down.
Mobley is there along with Aldridge.
This was more the action of 11's carrying that ball high and away. It looked like he was about to kick it forward. Second and 10. Favre changes plays at the line of scrimmage. Pumps and throws. Intercepted, blocked by Steve Atwater. He had a clean shot and a pick.
Well, Steve Atwater back in the middle of the field. Brett Favre changes the play. He sees the blitz. He's going to do a, they're going to do a pump and go, try to go deep. Atwater not fooled at all. He's just reading Brett Favre. I guess he's trying to look where he's going to run with the ball once he intercepts it. Doesn't concentrate and he drops an easy one.
You know, as Robert Brooks just looking at his eyes, he looked helpless because he knew he couldn't get to the ball to even knock it down. And then Atwater just drops it.
Atwater will force the fumble on a big hit of Favre in the opening half that set up the score. Third down. Favre, deep drop, screen play. And Levins is drilled at the 20, shy of the first down by 4 yards as Mobley and Alfred Williams read it well. Fourth down and on comes Ryan Longwell in the field goal unit for the Packers. Longwell, an interesting story. He was picked up by the 49ers as a free agent out of California, his home Bend, Oregon, and then cut. And Green Bay picked him up as support for Brett Conway, and Conway never played in the regular season. Longwell did. 39 yards to tie it up. Flag is down, and the kick is good. Now, against whom is this penalty?
It's against Denver, Brian, or Alfred Williams, number 91.
That would be a first down if they elect to take the penalty, or do you take the 3 and the tie?
Well, you're going to get a first down is what's going to happen if Denver's offside.
Offside by the defensive left guard. It's a 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down. The field goal does not count.
The one thing you cannot do, look inside. He jumps. Anytime you're kicking a field goal, the offense on defense, if it's 4th or 5 and less, your number one goal, don't jump off sides. That time Alfred trying to get the jump to get in there, block the field goal.
It makes it senseless. He's right over the ball. He can see the ball.
So the confident Packers spurring the 3 to go for 7. The give to Levins. Levins trying to get outside. Braxton makes the tackle at the 15. No gain.
Well, the one thing you're seeing with this Denver defense, what it's built on and why it's working so far today is speed. Tyrone Braxton, he's on the inside. Watch him. Here he comes in your picture. Beats the block of William Henderson, the fullback, gets out and makes the tackle.
This is what they wanted to get Dorsey Levins to do. They want him to run a shot coming up the field like they do Terrell Davis. They want to get him moving. As long as he's moving, he's less powerful.
He's had a big game, Braxton. 32, now 33-year-old veteran. Incomplete, and for the first time, Freeman, as he's hit by Crockett, unable to make the tough catch. He's been pulling in receptions and traffic the entire game.
Well, we wondered coming in the game, how would Denver play defense? They've been aggressive all year long. Today, they're doing it again. Steve Atwater times the blitz. Perfect time, and he comes in. Nobody blocking him. This time, Smart jumps and knocks the ball down.
So Atwater deflecting the ball and ruining the pass plans of Favre. Now this is where Brett Favre has been so brilliant throughout the past 3 years. Third and long, getting the first down or more. Flag down, and Adam Timmerman, the right guard, maybe a false start.
Before the snap, false start by the offense, number 63. 5-yard penalty, it's still third down.
Here's the right guard, Timmerman. Now, just watch him. As soon as he moves, the winner's making some sense.
He caught himself, dip. Though. Good
yeah,
balance.
He did. He's got great balance, got good heels.
Third and 15, so Denver D is tightening. 5 plays for the Packers on this drive and only 6 yards. Braxton coming up. And another whistle before the play. Usually that's against the offense. Frank Winters, the snapper, might have moved the ball.
False start, snap infraction by the offensive center. Double clutch. 5-yard penalty, it's still third down.
The old double clutch.
Now they move it back to the 25-yard line.
You know, Frank Winters, the center, number 52. Brett Favre, we saw a little piece before the game. Sometimes if Brett Favre throws the ball down the field and throws it to the wrong guy, Frank Winters says, you know, Brett, you got to throw it to the open guy. I wonder if Brett got in the huddle this time. Is any Frank? How about on the right snap count?
Well, 20 yards for a first down from the 25. The gift to Levins, and Levins finds a good height and is all the way to the 9-yard line before they tackle him. It'll be short of the first down, but a big pickup of nearly 20 yards. So Ryan Longwell, who has already kicked a 39-yard field goal, but there was a penalty on the play, and Green Bay decided to go for the touchdown. Now Longwell will get a closer shot. This one will be from about 27 yards. To tie the game. And he's got it. 17-17. Terrell Davis, first play of the second half. The fumble leads to a Green Bay field goal. They start anew, tied at 17 with 11 minutes 59 seconds left in the third quarter. Elway on the field just briefly with Davis fumbling on the first scrimmage play. Longwell kicks it again, same spot, 10-yard line. Vaughn Hebron up the sidelines, 25, and hit at the 27, 28-yard line. Let's go back to a missed opportunity by Steve Atwater that would have denied Green Bay the field goal.
When you look at this and Atwater missing this ball, this is, you can consider this a turnover, Dick. I mean, he has the ball. They get the ball back, and the ball goes through his hand. And when you look down the sideline, Phil said before we went to break that they were all on the blitz, so there was nobody to the outside. He might have been able to score.
Well, he's not paid for catching so much as he is for making big hits. In fact, Atwater had only two interceptions this year. And he's out to the 34-yard line before Bernardo Harris can make the tackle.
What I noticed about the Denver offensive line, once they make contact with the defensive lineman of Green Bay, look at this. You just can't get away from the blockers. That enables Terrell Davis to get through the hole. And again, the linebackers making the tackles around the ankles, preventing the big play.
Second down, Davis again. Picking his hole, and as he hit hard at the 35-yard line by Gilbert. You could hear that one throughout the stadium.
Well, Nealon's been handling Gilbert Brown most of this ball game, and this time Gilbert Brown is not going to be denied. Number 93, watch this. There's a double team. Watch it. Bam! Right through the double team.
Well, Gilbert Brown had some problems the first half. Nealon doing a pretty good job on him. 66, Nealon going to the Pro Bowl. They run him wide. And on the goal line, knock Gilbert Brown off the ball. That is no mean feat. So third down and two. Elway, lots of time. Now it open. Going to have to throw it away. Drew threw it, and the coverage incomplete. Tyrone Williams was all over Rod Smith.
Well, this play, we saw the Denver Broncos work on this in practice many times. They were hoping to get Shannon Sharp open down the field. He was well covered, and John Elway, he does something a veteran quarterback should not do. He throws a desperation pass that's almost picked off.
Elway only 5 for 10 in the game, just 27 yards passing. Robert Brooks drifts back to his 20. Tom Ruin, who kicked for the University of Colorado, had a 47-yard punt, his only kick of the opening half. Short. Not a good kick, but it takes a Denver bounce. And is down inside the 25-yard line by Dedrick Dodge. Timeout, 17-17. Ball at the 26-yard line. Packers and Favre go to work. Levins. His best running has come in the second half. Most of this year, Hasselbeck makes the tackle. Levin's first halves of games in the postseason, 67 yards. Then he runs it up to 159 and a couple of touchdowns in the second half. This big, sturdy 230 pounder wears down those defenses. Likes to run it right up the middle, as you can see. 82 yards thus far. Second and six. Levin's again cuts back. Pushes to the 33-yard line. Let's go to Randy Cross.
Thank you, Dick. You know, Brett Favre is the best quarterback in the NFL right now because he's the best when he has to be the best. And so far today on third down, he's having a good day. 5 of 5 so far. All completions, one touchdown in that, and 4 first downs. That's it from here, Dick. Back to you.
Okay, Randy, and that's certainly living up to his esteemed reputation. Third down, doesn't matter. Third and 25, somehow he makes a play. That's why he is the MVP for the third consecutive year. He throws behind his receiver this time, incomplete. So the Denver defense and the Green Bay defense playing very tough the first couple of possessions of this half.
And what's happening, I'm watching Brett Favre, and he's very confused underneath center. He's changing plays. That time he's expecting just man coverage on the outside. Denver at the last second drops back. They got him double covered. There's nowhere to throw the football.
We saw Greg Robinson, how happy the defensive coordinator was with that effort. Hendrick to punt. Darian Gordon. Denver would love to see him get a chance. Oh, very high. What a kick. Gordon back to his 15. And they got him at the 14.
Travis Jervey.
From the Citadel, 54 yards on the kick and no return. He's on his way to the Pro Bowl, Jervey. There is a flag on the play, however, back at the line of scrimmage.
Offsides on Denver is the
now let's wait for referee Hockley. If it's offside Denver, it was 4th and 4, that'd be a first down.
Offsides by the defense number 32 lined up in the neutral zone. The penalty is declined. Denver keeps the ball, first down.
Wow. Wow. That was a first down if they take the penalty.
There it is on the line of scrimmage. I mean, you've really got to pay attention on special teams. Now,
correction.
Yeah, I would.
Accepting the penalty will result in a first down. Green Bay accepts the 5-yard penalty, offsides. First down.
You know, you really have to be aware of where you are. I'm telling you, on the football field, you look down the line of scrimmage, these are dumb mistakes. We had Alfred Williams offside on a field goal, but only got a field goal out of it afterwards.
Paul, we always said all year long, if you make a mistake before the ball is snapped,
that's a mental mistake.
Yeah, that is a mental mistake. That's a dumb penalty. Those are the things that always drive the coaches. They drive them crazy. You work on this constantly to line up offsides in 4th and 4. Hard to forgive it.
Did you see Homer looking like, who refused that? I'll kill him.
First down for the Packers at the 38. Dangerous business when you give Favre all the extra chances. And Dorsey Levin's straight ahead again to the 41-yard line to pick up about 3.5 trailer. And Aldridge make the stop.
Bill Romanowski, he's going crazy here on this play. He wants I guess the tight end, he thinks he moved in front of him. He wants the flag thrown. He's the only one who saw it. Oh.
The fans watching on the Giants scoreboard saw that replay, and a little slap by Romo has been fined some $27,000 this year for a bad hit and the spitting violation in San Francisco. Favre on the roll. Incomplete out of the field of play. Robert Brooks, the closest white jersey. Ray Crockett covering.
You know, Dick, what is your impression of Romanowski when you sit there and talk to him? We talked to him the other day for about a half an hour. He's just so low-keyed about, and everything is so a matter of fact.
He talked, you know, I think we're going to really play hard. He's got that kind of voice, and those eyes are so big.
Yeah.
Don't be deceived by that smile.
Well, it's like Bill Cowher told us before the AFC Championship game. He says, Bill Romanowski, he has all the moves. And he means he knows how to hold and not get caught. All the things that enable him to do his job a little better.
Would you want him on your team?
Absolutely.
Third down for Favre.
throws under pressure. Incomplete. Intended for Brooks. Crockett on the coverage. Favre, just as he threw, was hit.
Well, Brett Favre again never sees the blitz. It's from his backside. And if he has to hold the ball just a little bit longer, watch Steve Atwater. Just a little bit late getting started on the snap of the ball. Otherwise, he's going to hit Brett Favre before he throws it and calls a fumble.
Atwater kind and pulling up on Favre. Had a clean shot. So Gordon again back at his 15 as Hendrick, who drilled that 54-yarder last time, sends his right foot into it. Another beautiful high kick, a little shorter. Fair catch, Gordon. And fumbles the ball. And now in trouble at the 1 yard line, he's tackled. The flag is down again. Chris Darkins, the rookie from Minnesota, made the tackle along with Travis Jervey. And the flag is down back at the line of scrimmage.
Well, Randy Hilliard and Travis Jervey really are getting into it.
Jervey voted the best special teamer, goes to the Pro Bowl for the NFC, and this one, the legal man downfield against Green Bay.
So what was, you know, Mike Holmgren told us a quick story about Travis Jervey.
Jervey goes in his third year. He said, first of all, he's a real character.
A member of the kicking team, the center, was ineligibly downfield before the ball was kicked. It's a 5-yard penalty, repeat fourth down. It's number 60.
So Jervey, the announcement's made, goes to Pro Bowl. Quite an honor. He comes to practice. He is beat, red, red, crimson.
Oh.
And he says, what happened to you? He said, well, I went out and rented me one of those tanning tubs, and I fell asleep. He said, I didn't want to go to Honolulu.
Now, wait, where did he go to school?
The
Citadel.
Oh.
What did Holmgren say? I met two guys.
From the Citadel.
McGuire and Jervey, and they're from the Citadel. What does that tell you about that school?
Well, he broke all your violation records there. Rod Smith now goes back after Gordon had trouble fielding the last punt. And another good high kick by Hendrick. Burkhead Smith at the 13. And a flag down.
Improper signal for the fair catch.
So Smith, who has not been used much as a kick returner this year, Gordon, that's been his specialty. And unfamiliar, perhaps has forgotten the proper signal.
Just have to put your hand up over your head. That's not too hard, is it?
51-yard kick, Hendrick.
Here we go.
Inbound fair catch signal by a member of the kicking team, number 80. It's a 5-yard penalty from the end of the kick. Denver keeps the ball, first down.
He was fair game.
Watch this. Watch his hand. Watch how quick it goes up. That. Now, I don't understand that. That is, to me, that's proper.
17-17 in the third. Special teamers are recognized for a second effort.
Continuous effort, too. Look at him. Randy Hilliard. Watch him going after Hilliard. Now, if the ball carrier was running by, Travis wouldn't even know he's around. But he's going to look at the end of this. He loses his helmet. The officials get off each other.
Randy Hilliard and Travis Jervey. That is quite an incident. As Elway throws over the middle incomplete, and Ed McCaffrey double-teamed, trying to feed one through Seth Joyner and Leroy Butler. And Elway just having trouble finding any open targets.
Well, there's nobody open down the field, and this time Ed McCaffrey coming across the middle. John Elway, the one thing you got to do as a quarterback when you throw across the middle, look in front of the receiver. Watch Leroy Butler, come into the screen. It's a good thing that ball went past Ed McCaffrey.
Denver, first half, great starts of their drive throughout the second half, and Elway has yet to complete a pass to his wide receiver. Five completions, and there is the, no, it's a Shannon Sharp, the tight end, with a sliding catch, and Sharp near a first down, his fourth catch of the game.
Well, Shannon Sharp, they love to split him out, get him away from all the traffic inside sometimes. This time he's covered by a corner, Tyrone Williams. That's what Shannon Sharp likes to do. Come down, put his hands on the defender, go inside and get open.
Shannon Sharp.
And tall.
Yeah, he
talked to him.
He actually practices, admits he goes in front of the mirror 20 minutes, practices interviews. He wants to make sure he's got the good answer.
It's working.
Third and short. And Terrell Davis skids out to the 20 and a first down.
That's the initial first down of the second half for the Denver Broncos.
This play is a classic example of how good their offensive line is and how much confidence they have in it. Everybody on Green Bay knows that Terrell Davis is going to carry the ball. Look at the blocking at the point of attack. Now that is just outstanding. T-Bone Brown gets Reggie White turned. First down.
And that is only the second Denver first down since the first quarter. Davis now has rushed more and gained more yards than anyone in NFL history in a season. He just broke John Riggins for the most carries in a season, broke Eric Dickerson most yards in a season, regular and playoffs. Davis again gets the call on first down. Now 83 yards in the game. And there, this is a combining regular and playoffs. John Riggins in 83. And remember, Riggo capped off that great year in the Super Bowl as he had the winning touchdown against Miami. Game played at the Rose Bowl. Second and six. Davis. For a first down at the 31-yard line. Doug Evans finally drags him down.
Well, Terrell Davis, one thing he's done all year long, talking to Fritz Sherman, the defensive coordinator of the Green Bay Packers, he says if this offensive line of Denver's, if they make a hole, he always finds it. And you think he's not thinking about that fumble, the first carry of the second half? When there's somebody even in the vicinity, he's putting both arms around that football.
There they call him the old rattler, Fred Shermer.
Yeah, the old rattler. He lost one of his fangs, all the players said. So he's
Well, what a coach. Play action, Elway. Fires deep down the middle. Open is McCaffrey. And a first down inside the 35. Finally, to a wide receiver, and it's a big one, 36 yards.
Well, this time, Denver, good job of scripting a play that works. Ed McCaffrey just comes right down the middle of the zone between this defender and the corner outside. John Elway, play action fake, looks to the left, creates the big hole to the right, keeps the safety out of the way, and Ed McCaffrey makes sure of the catch.
Look at the difference. So he has a throwing lane. The offensive line is blocking where it all starts there, and if he has time, he's going to find an open man.
Played at Stanford. Davis, quick hitter up the middle. Gains down to the 27-yard line and is now 2 yards away from the century mark, Terrell Davis.
As Phil Simms talked about before, watch explosion. Explosion by Terrell Davis. Bam, he gets the ball. He's got both hands on it. Look at the hole in the middle of that line.
You see, Paul, again, the Denver offensive linemen, when they're making contact right now with the Green Bay defensive line, Green Bay cannot get off the blocks. They're letting Terrell Davis get to the line of scrimmage and barrel through for those extra yards.
What is that? I like those numbers. A running back gaining 100 a game in the postseason. The completion is to McCaffrey and a first down at the Green Bay 16. 9 on the play.
Does McCaffrey take unusual hits, or does he just make it look like it's unusual?
Well, Ed McCaffrey, they got a nickname for him out in Denver, the media does. They call him the Bruise, because after games, he just has a way of taking a lot of hits. But after games, he takes his jersey off, and of course, there's all these marks on his body, and they're bruises, and they could swear there's a tattoo right on his ribs that says, insert the helmet here.
So. Former New York Giant receiver with Phil Simms, played with the 49ers in State Line. Skids into the 14-yard line, a pickup of 2. Brian Williams made the stop. You're just joining us. Super Bowl 32 is tied at 17. We're in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining.
Gilbert Brown's engine's about to run out. Gilbert is having a tough time getting up the field and off the field.
Go ahead, Paul, get a look at Gilbert Brown, number 93, inside.
All right, there's Dalen blocking him. Look at they just cut him. Habib comes in, number 75, and just cuts him at the legs.
That's what they want to do when the play goes away. The backside guy just cut Gilbert Brown. Don't try to push him around.
On second down, Davis having trouble hearing the change of play by Elway. It's to Davis, and Davis gets very little. Good defensive charge by the Packers with Gilbert Brown in on that stop. And good support from the linebacker. Davis now 102 yards in this Super Bowl 32. And that's without playing in the second quarter, a mild concussion.
Well, so many people wondered coming in this game. They talk about the matchups. And everybody said, do you really think Denver can run the ball in Green Bay? And my answer always is, they've run it every single game this year. Why would the Super Bowl be any different?
Good point. 11th play of this drive that started back at the Bronco 8. Third and 6, Elway shotgun. Almost offside, but the Packers got back on. Elway scrambling, looking, running, diving inside the 5-yard line for a first down. Is he only 37? How important is this football game? How bad does John Elway want to win this football game? When you see that quarterback go down, not Elway.
Watch John Elway. He does a good job. He steps up. Watch him look to the sideline here. He knows where he's got to go for the first down. The only way he's going to get there is a sellout. He does it and protects the football.
Three Packers simultaneously sandwich and cartwheel Elway. It's first and goal. Elway with 4 rushes for 18 yards. And, of course, in his early days, one of the great quarterback scramblers. They told you has run the football more than any quarterback in history. First and goal. The eyes of Elway. First and goal. 12th play of the drive from the 4. Davis driving close to the 1-yard line. Down low, Bernardo Harris to make the tackle. As the clock ticks inside a minute in the third quarter. 27-yard passings first half, but 53 in this drive. The big ones to Ed McCaffrey.
And the biggest thing John Elway has done so far today, he's managed the game very well, but it's 3 runs picking up timely first downs and 1 for a touchdown.
This drive over 7 minutes as Davis scores. Just shows you the power of Terrell Davis. It's Bernardo Harris that's on his back when he decides to take him into the end zone with him. Number 55 is Bernardo Harris. Look at this. He hits him there at the 1. Terrell Davis into the end zone with him.
Just give Terrell Davis a little hope. A little hope, and he makes a lot out of it.
106 yards and 2 touchdowns for Terrell Davis. At his high school number retired here in San Diego this week. Elam kicks the extra point. 34 seconds left in the third quarter. 92 yards for the touchdown and the lead, 24-17. Elam. To Antonio Freeman. Recovers the ball.
What happens? Antonio Freeman, he's returning the kick. It's supposed to go up the middle. There's nothing there. He breaks to his left. There's no blocking over there. The ball's in his right hand to the defender when he gets hit. That's one of the reasons why he fumbles.
Elway watches Tony Veland, the first-year defensive back from Nebraska, make the hit, and McCaffrey recover the fumble at the Green Bay 22. 22 seconds left in the third quarter. Fake to Davis. Elway fires to the end zone. Intercepted by Green Bay. Robinson going to take it out. Was he down by contact? No, apparently returns to the 15-yard line. Runs over an official in the process. And just like that, Green Bay makes the big play.
John Elway on the play. They're going for the score. They're going for the kill. He takes a chance. Eugene Robinson's back in the middle of the field. The play action fake. Elway looks left. When he looks back to the right, a good move by Rod Smith. But Eugene Robinson read the quarterback, makes the break, and gets the interception.
Eugene Robinson, who has made a great career out of picking off opposing quarterbacks. On the season, had only 1 this year, but has 49 in his great career. A free agent out of Colgate, is the leading active interceptor, a leader of this team. Man who walked on in college, 160 pounds at Colgate.
And he's picked off Elway four times. Of course, many of those came while he was starring in the defensive backfield of the Seattle Seahawks.
He did not go for the fake by Elway's eyes to the left. He stayed where he was supposed to.
Now it's Favre. He unloads down the middle, complete. Freeman in open territory, out of bounds at the 40. Oh, it's a sub game. 2 seconds left in the third period. They'll wind those off, and that's how this quarter will end.
Well, they got him in a blitz again, Phil, and it's man-to-man coverage on the outside. You just take it. Look at Antonio Freeman comes underneath. Watch at the end of this play, though. Watch Chimura come in. Bam, right here. Hello.
Oh, my. We go to the fourth quarter. 24-17 Denver. We'll be back after these messages.
John Elway on the sidelines, ruining the opportunity. Went for the kill after the fumble recovery at the 22 on the kickoff return, but intercepted by the KG Eugene Robinson. We open the fourth quarter. 24-17 Broncos. Favre first down at his own 42. Pump fake and the long throw. And that should be, and is called interference at the Denver 35-yard line. Robert Brooks, Darian Gordon was there too soon.
Is this one of those plays, Phil, that we saw during the course of the year where it's thrown short, or it wasn't on purpose?
No, he wasn't trying to do that on purpose. He was trying to lead it out. Doesn't make a great throw, but
pass interference by the defense, number 23, automatic first down.
But what happens under underthrows, the defender, they're trying to run full speed down the field with the wide receiver, Darian Gordon, and then when the receiver turns around, it's hard for Darian Gordon to stop and find the ball. That's what makes him create the penalty.
They mark it at the 33, a 25-yard penalty. Is Favre fires to this side, complete to Brooks, tackled immediately by Ray Crockett, a 3-yard loss.
Well, I could hear him changing the plays because he was saying black, and that's their live color for this game. And every time he yells that, they're trying to get rid of the play they have at the line of scrimmage.
You know what? It's really a good indication for me is when Henderson, the fullback, lines up in a position, then
he
moves someplace
else.
I think it's a good indication.
It's always a dead giveaway. You can't audible in this league without giving away to the defense.
Give Brooks a 3-yard gain on the pass reception. Second down and 7. Favre.
Wide open to the middle, and the first down at the 14-yard line is Antonio Freeman. Again, a punishing tackle, hangs onto the ball. Atwater drills him.
Well, Darian Gordon fell down. Yes.
What happens this time? The Denver Broncos, they come on the blitz inside. It's picked up. And again, anytime you blitz, look at all the people come inside. Look at all that area underneath. There's no defenders underneath the wide receivers. Brett Favre sees it, throws a strike in there.
Freeman, 7 catches, 107 yards. First down at the 13. Favre to the end zone. Touchdown! It's to Antonio Freeman. Freeman's second touchdown of the game. His third in 2 Super Bowls, 13 yards, and this game is one extra point away from being tied again.
Well, you know, when I looked at that, you talk about open. I mean, there was just no competition at all.
Boy, they really picked on Darian Gordon on that series. Longwell adds the extra point. It's 24-24. Brett Favre to his favorite target, Antonio Freeman. It's even again. Welcome back to San Diego. Brett Favre didn't waste any time. He was 4 for 4, 60 yards passing. It took only 4 plays and a penalty for Green Bay to tie it up. 85-yard drive. Everyone at the end. Tackled at the 22. Let's go back to the touchdown. Wide open, Antonio Freeman.
A blitz by the Denver Broncos. It's man coverage on the outside. They call this scissors. The receivers go down. They cross each other. Looks like a pair of scissors. Denver gets caught in the swap. Wide open for the touchdown, and Antonio Freeman.
Could have thrown either one of them, Brooks or him.
And don't forget, that drive started after Eugene Robinson denied Elway.
The Broncos had scored a touchdown, recovered the fumble on the ensuing kickoff, only to have Robinson pick off Elway in the end zone. Well, back comes a 15-year veteran from Stanford, Elway. Terrell Davis to the 25-yard line, and a flag down, a gain of three. Harrison Williams made the stop. Holding against the Broncos. That'll take them back to the 12-yard line.
Holding by the offense, number 75, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Brian Habib, veteran right guard.
Brian Habib, the right guard, they're going left. He's probably trying to get a cutoff block on Gilbert Brown. And he sticks his hand up, and I guess that's the hold.
Boy, that is a terrible call. I mean,
thank you, Paul.
Wasn't it?
Yes.
Considering there hasn't been a holding call in the whole game, it must have been worse than that.
So first down and 20. Elway. The shotgun gets to Davis on a draw. John Dockery has a report.
You know, Dick, this game, the Packer defense is like a heavyweight fighter on the ropes. They're looking for healthy bodies to throw in on the defensive line. You know that Gabe Wilkins is out with a left knee problem. His replacement, Darius Holland, has a right ankle heavily taped. Reggie White, any number of times, is asked to come out of the game. And Gilbert Brown, the big man, was sucking wind along the sidelines after that last series. So they're hurting up front on the defensive line.
But they have Denver at second down 17, deep in the one end. Steps up, throws, complete, short yardage to Davis. Hangs on at the 18-yard line. Robinson racing up to hit him with a big tackle.
Eugene Robinson is just everywhere. Eugene Robinson is a safety, folks. And watch this. Terrell Davis is going to come out of the backfield. Elway has no place to go. So when he dumps it, as soon as he does, watch number 41. Right there to make the play.
Give progress to the 19. Eugene Robinson. Larry Bright was an academic scholar at Colgate. Plays the sacks, although his teammates say sounds like killing chickens. Third down and 13. Elway going deep for Willie Green. Intercept and then drop. No interception. Dropped by Darren Sharper, the rookie from William and Mary, who had a solid first season with the Packers. Had a couple of picks.
You would think Darren Sharper, a rookie on the outside against Willie Green, this would be a good matchup for the Denver Broncos, but they love this guy corner. He has the speed, the size, and he just has those good instincts to find the football. And Fritz Schirmer says he just happens to be one of these guys where the football seems to find him, to let him make the plays. And Willie Green, even though that's a penalty, that's a good play trying to prevent the interception.
You know, Sharper was injured from a outstanding athletic family. His brother Jamie, a linebacker who played at Virginia, was a number two pick of the Baltimore Ravens and played some solid football for them this year. And here's Sharper, who was also picked in the second round, contributing to the defending Super Bowl champs at Green Bay.
Well, Willie Green just grabbed him by the head and pulled him around, and Sharper landed on his face.
Says he's okay. He was two times a Division I-AA All-America at William & Mary.
You're always looking for corners in the NFL, but when you can find one, they thought maybe he'd be a safety because you can see the size of him. But when you're that big and you're able to go outside and defend against wide receivers, that is an added plus in the NFL.
Well, that mystery holding penalty, however, plays a very important role in Denver's inability to move the ball. So ruin in the punt with Robert Brooks back inside the Packer 40. 11 minutes 32 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Another short hit. And the Green Bay bounce and down at the 48-yard line. Ruin didn't hit that at all. 33 yards. For the Packers, short kick at the 48. The game is tied at 24. 11:23 left. Favre swings it. Levens close to a first down as he's run out at the 42-yard line by Alfred Williams and Darian Gordon. Randy?
Thank you, Dick. Let's take a look at what Brett Favre is doing with his football today, passing. You know, coming into this game, you said, hey, Elway's going to have to run the field this air with footballs. Well, so far, Brett Favre is getting these balls all over the place. He's completed 19 passes. Here's the completions, the touchdowns. You get the incompletions zapping in here next. They're going to win this ball in the air and on the right side. Back to you, Dick.
All right, Randy. Favre has had a solid game as he has all season long. 204 yards and three touchdowns. First down at the Denver 42. Baked 11s. The throw. Incomplete. One of the few that he has misfired. Favre doesn't miss many. He overshot Freeman.
Well, look at Freeman's laughing. Favre's hitting himself in the head because he knows he's got him wide open, and Favre knows it's his fault. Not Antonio Freeman's fault. Watch Favre.
My fault.
Uh-oh, you.
You know, Brett Favre, after he throws the ball, he has a lot of yards after throw. He's one of the, he likes a lot of body English, and he laughs about it. He says, in practice, I never do it. I stand there nice and relax and throw it. But he says, once the game starts, I throw it, and I start backpedaling, trying to somehow get it into the receiver.
Met after a short game of Bill Romanowski there first.
Bill Romanowski, you know, you said you'd love to have him on your football team. He just is a tough football player. He's got a great sense of where the ball is. Look at this. I mean, he is not even touched in the hole, in the right place at the right time. You know, the other thing about Favre, talking to him, it's so funny. When he hands the ball out, the first time we did him, back way back in, what, September or something, he says, well, I hand the ball out. He kind of dances around. He says, I don't know what to do. After I hand it out, yeah, he gets bored.
Third and eight. The blitz. And the throw. And that corner knocks it away at the last minute. Brooks was open.
Well, Denver, third and long situations. They're trying to send more people than Green Bay can pick up. Watch the blitz coming from inside. Here comes Darian Gordon. He's untouched. Brett Favre buys the extra time, really anticipates across the field, and it takes a terrific play by Steve Atwater to stop the touchdown.
You see what Henderson did? I'm sorry, Dick. He reaches out and grabbed Gordon by the arm.
10-18 left, and Gordon back as Henrick sends up a high floater. And Gordon fair catches at the 17-yard line. So the Broncos have the ball. 10 minutes and change remaining in the fourth. John Elway and the Broncos have the ball at their own 18-yard line in this tie game at 24. Here are the leading passers in NFL history, none of whom has enjoyed a Super Bowl win. Marino, Elway, Moore, Moon, Tarkenton, and Fouts. Elway, 0-3.
Isn't that amazing? Look at those names that haven't been to a Super Bowl or won a Super Bowl.
Only 84 yards passing for Elway in this game. Hands it off to Davis, trying to get outside. Cuts back. Breaking tackles to the 32-yard line. Another first down. 14 yards for Davis.
John Dockery just said something down there just a few moments ago. This defensive line and linebacker, these guys are tired. They are tired.
Only the zero for Migraine. Hit in the head, and that, of course, he's had migraine problems throughout his career, Terrell Davis, as you see this run, and hasn't had anything seriously hit him since early, what, about October against San Diego a year ago.
Don't try to arm tackle that man.
123 yards for Davis. He gets the call again. At the middle of 35, a gain of nearly five. Darius Holland, the tackler. We haven't called Reggie White's number much today.
Well, there may be a reason for it. And here comes the reason.
One, he gets double teamed, the changing, the blocking up on Reggie White all day long. And then when he tries his patented club move, Tony Jones, the right tackle, he's a big guy. It's hard to move him with one arm.
Number 77, Jones, has done a great job on the all-time defensive end. Lead to Dwayne Carswell, the second tight end, his first catch. Brian Williams makes the tackle. It's short of a first down at the 40. It'll be third down in about a yard and a half. We mentioned both quarterback sons of coaches. There's Jack Elway, a longtime coach, and he's agonizing with every play. This would complete the portfolio of signing a Super Bowl game. He's done everything else.
first down to the 43. Needed two, got three.
You know, you said something in the first quarter about cutback, about they go right, he cuts back. He's done it every single time. And the problem is that the Green Bay Packers defensive line are tired. They're not moving.
They're tired, and you just never think of these situations and running the ball. That time, they're running the right. And Terrell, as soon as he sees a little daylight back to the left, he takes it. But it just shows you the backside of the offensive line away from the run. Very important that they get their blocks. They've been doing a terrific job of it today.
First down at the 43. Midpoint of the fourth quarter. There's never been an overtime game in a Super Bowl. Running out of trouble. Looked as if there'd be no gain, and managed about three before Santana Dotson and Brian Williams could chase him down.
We were talking about Gilbert Brown and Reggie White sucking wind down there. You think there are any bugs around those guys? They've eaten them all.
There can't be a bug in that whole area, Dennis. Oh. Look at this.
Reggie's tired. Gilbert's tired.
Well, we mentioned that the Denver offensive line is the lightest in the entire league, but they're also lean and well-conditioned.
Very, that's right, and they're making the Green Bay defense play both aspects of the game. You got to sit in there and be tough to stop the run, and then every once in a while when you get in a passing situation, they got to try to get up the field. They use a lot of energy.
Elway, double pumps, and then Taylor's complete. First down at the Green Bay 42. Shannon Sharp cradles it in front of Eugene Robinson and Tyrone Williams.
Boy, it really helps. It helps to be big and strong and have arms the size of legs. Shannon Sharp just uses his strength on the outside against Tyrone Williams, and that's what creates the play. That and John Elway's strong arm, because he double pumped. He's fallen away from the receiver and still whips it in there.
Those are 21-inch biceps. Shannon Sharp. Davis. Head down, plows to the 38. Bernardo Harris makes the tackle, and the clock moves toward 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
You know, when they talk about the offensive line of the Denver Broncos, Phil, and they say they're the lightest line, but what you're really looking at is 5 or 6 pounds, you know?
Yeah, we're nitpicking, Paul. You're right. And you know the big thing about this line? They're very active. They block on angles. They block to the right. The other guys pull around and kick out, and you can't have big... Well, you can't have big fed guys doing that.
Second and seven, Elway, fake, throw, goes long to Smith. Incomplete. Defended well by Tyrone Williams. It was Williams who replaced the injured Craig Newsome. Newsome requiring knee surgery very early in this season. And Williams stepped in his second year out of Nebraska and has been solid.
Boy, is this excellent coverage by Tyrone Williams, using all of his speed. Look at that. He turns and looks for the ball, then stays in front of the receiver, gets his hands up, doesn't get up there too early to allow Rod Smith to go over and make the catch.
And Elway, who is stuck on 100 yards passing for the entire game and an interception in the end zone. Now a critical third and seven. Has to throw it away. A fourth down and seven.
You know, there is no hesitation. You punt the ball. Of course, this is in Tom Ruin. It's in his area. He's hadn't been able to hit the ball more than 30 yards anyway, so it shouldn't hurt him.
You know, you're really hard.
Well,
he's hard on punters.
Well, yeah, when you did.
He's hard. Yeah,
you kick for a living in this league, you know. He wants perfect.
They only pay you to do one thing. You should be able to do it.
Mike Pryor is one of the deep backs now, along with Robert Brooks, standing at the 10. This is usually where they kick it right over the end zone into the crowd. No, very high. That's well placed.
Beautiful.
Fair catch by Brooks at the 10-yard line. Oh, Brett Favre and the Packers 90 yards away with 5:25 left in the fourth quarter. The Packers, the Broncos at 24. 25 left. They're tied at 24. Green Bay trying to repeat back-to-back Super Bowl wins, a la the Vince Lombardi years when they won the first two in this great series. The Denver Broncos looking for their first Super Bowl trophy. They've lost four times. This man, John Elway, has been the losing quarterback three times. He's used his legs more than his arm today to give the Broncos a chance, but it's Favre at his own 11-yard line, the deepest they've been since that 5-yard line. He throws to Henderson, runs right through a tackle. Ray Crockett could not bring him down, and Alan Aldridge did.
Well, every play is a big play now with only 5 minutes to go in the game. The Broncos in a good coverage to stop this play. Ray Crockett, he's looking into the backfield. He sees it. Come up and make the tackle for a 1 yard gain. William Henderson says, I don't think so.
Crockett's 184 and Henderson is nearly 250. A gain of 7. Favre trying to make something happen. Throwing downfield. Incomplete. Crockett leaping in front of Robert Brooks. Flag down. Holding against Green Bay.
You know, there was a time when that play there, when Favre threw that ball, he trusted his arm. He just thought that I could outthrow the defensive back.
I don't think Brett Favre has never not trusted his arm.
No. Yep. But, I mean, when you can see the defensive back, they had Brooks long and short, and he just tried to fire it in.
Holding by the offense, number 78. 10-yard penalty after the specific call. Repeat second down.
What happens and why this is a holding penalty by Ross Verba? It's a screen to the inside, and it just takes way too long for the play to develop. He gets caught. Alfred Williams goes inside, catches Ross Verba with the speed, puts his arm out. The official sees that.
Penalty mark back to just outside the 7-yard line. 4 minutes, 41 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter of Super Bowl 32.
Denver's going to.
This already is moving high up on the list of memorable Super Bowl games with so many lopsided contests through this run of NFC championships and even back to the early days of the final game of the NFL season. Tied at 24, 4:41 left. Bad spot, and apparently they're going to correct that. Should be the 9-yard line. Oh, we're going to leave it just across the 8. Second and a dozen. Complete to Freeman again, and Antonio Freeman, who had a big Super Bowl game a year ago, caught an 81-yard touchdown from Favre. Remember, the longest ever. And today, Freeman with 9 catches, 126 yards, and 2 touchdowns. The record for most catches in a Super Bowl, as I recall, is 11. Big third down. And the Alfred Williams is already in the backfield, and now the flags fly. And a late flag, so unless Williams can convince the officials that the tackle move, that's on him.
It would be on Verba. Again, a holding penalty.
False start by the offense, number 78. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Verba is the first-round pick of the Packers this year out of Iowa. So good that he beat out the incumbent, John Michaels.
You see Verba right here. Now, Alfred Williams is looking at him, and Verba, well, you know,
he flinched.
He does. You can't, even if you're looking down at the line of scrimmage, once you get set, and again, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point stance makes no difference. You can't move.
Third and 11. Five. Scrambling. Throws incomplete, wide open was Antonio Freeman, but Favre throwing against his body was not accurate.
Where there's pressure in the pocket, Brett Favre is moving. He does a good job buying that extra time to throw the ball, but watch, he's running almost full speed to his left, tries to whip it, sidearm, misses a tough throw. Antonio Freeman can't make it.
John Elway, hey, way to go, Brett.
Give me a chance. Darian Gordon back at the Denver 44, kicking from his end zone is Craig Hunter. This one very short. Fair catch by Gordon at the 49-yard line of Green Bay. 39 on the punt. 3:27 left in the fourth. At time, the AFC won a Super Bowl. Ronald Reagan was just beginning his second term as president. Been a long drought. Elway pitches to Terrell Davis. Shreds one tackle. Breaks a couple more, and then flags fly. Could be face mask against Green Bay. Eugene Robinson made the tackle, and Davis says, they can't grab me up here.
It's on Darius Holland, number 90. He got in the backfield. He was in a position, but when Terrell Davis caught back inside, he grabbed the face mask.
Allen playing a lot in this Super Bowl 32 with the injury early to Gabe Wilkins, a knee.
Well, you get in this situation, personal foul.
Well, that's that. If that's personal that's foul, 15. That's 15.
That's the discussion. Was it incidental or a personal foul? And they. Well, here's the official word.
Personal foul, face mask by the defense, number 90, 15 yards penalty, automatic first down.
You can't grab and ride it. If you grab it, you gotta let go.
All right, here it comes. Here's Terrell Davis. And look at this. He put. See there when they call it. Look at his head. His head will really determine. If you turn his head all the way around, Dick, then they're gonna call, get you for 15. And this is that's just a sign of being tired.
But lost in all that, Davis takes that kind of yank on his helmet, turning him back, and still moves forward. He's going to get a lot of votes for the most valuable player in this game. 138 yards and sitting out the entire second quarter with migraines. Already the sixth most yards in Super Bowl history. Davis again. And this time Bernardo Harris bulldogs him down at the 30-yard line. He had his number retired, his high school number. Went to Lincoln High School here in San Diego. Same school Marcus Allen attended. He wore, interestingly, number 7, Elway's number. They had a big to-do at Lincoln High School. And he gave the young people there, the young students, a nice message. He said, don't let anyone steal your dreams. Keep your dreams alive. Well, look how far they've taken him.
They've taken him a long way. Really, Dick, that's what he said. I just want to give the young kids a sense of hope. There is something out there for them if they work hard.
2:39 left in the fourth quarter. Second and nine. Elway. Completes to Griffith. The first time from Griffith down the sideline to the 9-yard line.
Did you see the block of Ed McCaffrey? He just totally wiped out Brian Williams.
Griffith, who caught only 11 passes all year.
Look at see number 51. Well, you're going to watch him disappear in a moment, folks.
And McCaffrey down the field.
Here it comes right now. Goodbye. What a block by McCaffrey.
Mike Shanahan has said Ed McCaffrey is the best blocking wide receiver I've ever seen in the National Football League.
23 yards on the play. When we come back, Denver's at the Packer 8-yard line. Mike Holmgren stalking the Green Bay sidelines. Sees his team in trouble. Denver at the 8. 2 minutes to go. Neil Smith, who left Kansas City after so many great seasons with the Chiefs as an all-pro defensive end. They didn't sign him. Took a big pay cut to come to Denver because he thought they had the best chance of the teams that wanted him to get to the Super Bowl. And now the Broncos in a 24-24 tie have it first and goal at the 8, trying to beat this man, Brett Favre, few have in the last 3 years. The flag at the 8, and it looks as if it's holding Denver.
And Gilbert Brown is having a tough time getting up.
Shannon Sharp
acted as though it was on him.
It's got to be the way he was acting after the play.
Holding by the offense, number 84, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Of the many that don't like to see that is kicker Jason Elam. If they need a field goal, he'd like to be as close as he can get.
Shannon Sharp, this play has been cutting back up inside all day long. This time he takes it outside. He's on Seth Joyner, a big linebacker. They see the hands outside the shoulders. The official down the field, that's why he throws the flag.
If Seth would have had a flag, he'd have thrown it.
First and goal from the 18. Davis. Touchdown! No. He's out of bounds. They say now at the 1. Our view totally obscured by all the camera folks down on the goal line. He just missed the score. Tried to kick it in at the 1 and stepped on the line.
Aldo, just like last play, he keeps going inside, inside. Now he goes outside. What's Terrell Davis?
Good call.
1-yard line.
I'll tell you, Howard Griffith, number 29, has just been blocking like crazy in this game. You see, he's out of bounds. Yeah. Give it to him anyway.
Second and goal from the one with 1:47 left. You said, though, do you want to score too soon? It was a point you made, Paul, and Elway will use a timeout. That's the first Denver timeout. Each team has two remaining. That's important. Remember, in the third quarter, Green Bay called a timeout, so when they do get the ball back, they have but two remaining.
Terrell Davis has had, in this game, Dick, 27-yard run, a 10-yard run, a 16-yard run, a 14-yard run, and an 18-yard run. And when you look at this guy, 156 yards.
Well, he's been the runner-up to Barry Sanders for the rushing title the last 2 years. Here's a young kid. Remember, we saw him as a rookie. He said, oh, I was just so happy to, I was hoping I could make the special team squad. I had no idea they'd really want to use me as a runner.
He was hoping to make, he says, don't they have a taxi squad? Remember, that's what he said. I want to make that practice squad they have. And, well,
the first time we met him, folks, let me tell you, Dick Enberg likes to ask all these players that we talk to, what is your hobby? What do you like to do? You know what his hobby is? If you've never heard it before, you're going to hear it. He loves to sleep.
He's awake today. Second and goal at the one. Total in the game, 157 yards.
The difference, people have asked all week, we said in the open, the difference between this Bronco team and all the AFC teams that have come in and tried to win a Super Bowl, they can run the football, and they've done it all year long.
As Elam kicks the extra point, 1 minute, 45 seconds is a lifetime when Brett Favre is your quarterback, and he'll get a chance to tie it up.
You know, when you look at this hole, watch and see if you see any white shirts. Not many. Not in that hole. I mean, we talked about this. This is a tired, a very, very tired Green Bay Packer defensive line. Elway? Yes.
Well, Elway has not been the top of his game passing today, but the running attack of the Denver Broncos has been outstanding. This is the kind of running game that the NFC has brought to Super Bowl after Super Bowl after Super Bowl. Phil Simms and the New York Giants, not to take anything away.
No.
22 for 25.
Well, Dick, teams that win in the National Football League are usually the teams that beat up the other team physically. And when you run the football, that's what it takes. It takes physical players up front who can just out-muscle and out-hit the people across from them.
You notice the Denver Broncos are really excited, but they're not overexcited because they know what Favre can do.
Four straight 100-yard games in the postseason. Remember now, the Broncos are a wild card team, and only one wild card over 100 have entered the playoffs as wild card has gone all the way to win the Super Bowl, and that was in 1980, the Oakland Raiders beating the Eagles. Now Green Bay's turn. And the powerful Packers, with Freeman running it back, get to the 30-yard line. And here comes Favre. Keith Burns makes the tackle. And if anyone loves this role, it's this man. They call him Country from Little Kill, Mississippi. His dad, Irv, he calls him Hammerhead, coached him in high school. He just likes to have fun. It's a 28-year-old man, but he really behaves like a 12-year-old.
Well, tremendous talent. And if I was the Denver Broncos, I'm the defensive coordinator, Greg Robinson. I don't know what I do. Do you keep attacking, which they've done most of the day, or do you try to be a little conservative now and just hope one of your defensive players can just make a play physically?
Well, Robinson's made his choice. Three wide receivers for Favre. 1:39 left. Screen. Levens breaks a tackle, a big break of a tackle, and Levens powers to the 48 of Denver. They had him for five. He winds up with 22. Hurry up, 1:23, saving the two timeouts.
Boy, a good first call, always in a two-minute situation. A screen, a draw, gets the defense off guard. They come back.
Another screen. It was almost intercepted, and Levens is tackled for a short gain by Alfred
Williams and John Mobley. Williams was right there and almost got his hands up.
It was tipped, too. The ball was tipped.
Timeout Green Bay with 1:11. It's a 30-second timeout.
The first play, it's a screen play in the middle. Denver in a very conservative defense. John Mobley has him. Nobody's blocking him. He doesn't make the tackle. Look how long it takes for the Denver Broncos to react.
All right, here's the last one we're going to see where the tip comes in.
Tanabasa, number 98, tips it.
Up in the air.
Look at Alfred Williams.
Thinks he's going to get it.
He misses it.
And this was almost fumbled. They almost took it away again by Mobley.
Very close to Mobley coming up with that football.
You know, good thought by the Green Bay Packers. They run a screen on the second play, too. But Denver, they're kind of caught off guard. They can't even react and get up the field. So everybody's in the screen lane.
One timeout left for Mike Holmgren's Packers. Trailing 31-24.
Soft defense playing way off.
71 seconds left. Oh, what a good ad-lib throw. The Lions get out of bounds to stop the clock at the Denver 35.
How about this pirouette? I mean, Favre, when he's back there, you better go after me. You better hold on to him. You better force him to do something right now. Watch what Favre does here.
He looks right. Looks right. Nothing. Knows he has somebody swinging out the left. That is really a lot of good coaching and good schooling and Brett Favre learning it.
And another 13-yard gain. The NFC on a 13-year run in the Super Bowl. Ball at the 35. 1:04 left. The throw complete to Lions. Stopped at the 32-yard line. John Mobley didn't miss him this time. And Crockett there to help out. And the clock running. We'll see if Favre downs the ball to save some time. 48, 47 seconds. A lot of time running, and Green Bay fans getting nervous. Favre fires. Incomplete to Freeman. Gordon and Mobley were on him, but Freeman had a shot.
You know the one thing the Denver Broncos are doing that the Packers don't have that luxury, but their defensive line, they're running guys in and out of the game, and they're getting fresh people in all the time.
Well, what a throw there. Was that a bullet?
Well, sometimes Brett Favre looks down the field. John Elway, happy it's incomplete. He looks down the field and really they look covered, but to him they look open. He tries to stick it in there.
They better get some heat on Favre because they're really not getting close to him.
Denver confused. People running around.
Third and six. The blitz. And the throw incomplete. Oh, what a crushing tackle at the 10. Robert Brooks running into Steve Atwater. Let's hope they all get up.
Atwater just killed Randy Hilliard. I mean, Brooks gets down between him. He gets nailed. But Atwater hits Hilliard. I mean, watch this. Watch 27 is Atwater. Now Brooks goes down and he hits his own man. Brooks is down on the bottom of it. Wow. Now we know Atwater has had bad shoulders all year long.
Oh, what a collision. As Hilliard, defensive back from Northwest Louisiana State. Look at this. He's trying to cover Brooks and Atwater with a crushing hit. And this is how it feels at full speed.
Oh. You hear that? That's heading.
And both Atwater and Hilliard have not gotten up yet. So two defensive backs down. It's fourth down and six. Well, with two men injured, that'll be a timeout charge to Denver. Let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Dick. Before that last play in that collision, Ray Crockett came limping over. He could barely get here. He has a cramp in his left hamstring. They're trying to work it out feverishly over here on the sideline, but he's out, and if Atwater stays out, his last 32 seconds could be very interesting for the Denver defensive backfield. Dick?
All right, and here's another development with both. Freeman also is ruled injured, so with two injuries, both for Denver, two for Denver, one for Green Bay. They charge both teams with a timeout. So the Packers have no timeouts left in Denver one. We'll see how critical that is here with fourth down and six staring at Green Bay. Now both Atwater and Hilliard have to come out.
So it almost forces Denver. If you're Green Bay calling an offensive play here, Denver has to be playing a zone defense, playing soft. making sure they don't give up a big play in case their defenders can get back in after this.
With that, you're making sure they don't give up the big play, but you also got to make sure that they don't get a first down.
Well, you'd hope that would happen, but the biggest thing is don't give up the big play and let them tie the game and win.
Dedrick Dodge and Darius Johnson come in at the defensive back positions. The throw is in. John Mobley broke it up, and the Broncos are celebrating on the near sidelines.
Phil, they sold out. They ran a full-scale blitz at him.
Everybody blitzed with two defensive backs injured and out of the game. They send the ball. It makes Green Bay throw the ball before they want. It's knocked down by the defense.
With 28 seconds left, Denver takes over and downs at the 32. And the 13-year domination of the NFC apparently has come to an end. And the man, the sentimental favorite, the fans who didn't care about who won this game cared that John Elway got a Super Bowl ring. They've reserved his spot in the Hall of Fame. This man probably will get there too, but Elway's a cinch to go to Canton when he is eligible. You know, after he lost to Jacksonville last year, he went home and his sister called him and he broke down crying. His kids, his four children, had never seen their dad cry before. Many of you remember when your dads cry, how important it is. It was a low moment of his great career. This then will become the highest moment. The completion of a great career, a Super Bowl championship for John Elway and the Denver Broncos. Father, the coach, who has lived every moment of his son's career.
He was actually covering Shimura from up here.
Shannon Sharp, his brother Sterling, left the Packers before they won last year. So Shannon will bring home the Super Bowl ring. Season. And it certainly ended on a marvelous note if you're a football fan. A great game, two terrific teams, and Denver, the underdog, prevailing 31-24.
You know, Phil, you and I had a feeling all week long that this was going to be a terrific football game.
Well, Paul, I think we knew, or we had the suspicion. Games don't change just because it's the final one. We knew that the Broncos could run the football. I don't think the Green Bay Packers have faced a team all year that lines up and comes at you and can be as physical and has a running back of the style of Terrell Davis.
Well, much more of the trophy presentation we'll hear from the men who wrote the story here in San Diego tonight. And, of course, that will include John Elway. We'll be back after these messages from your local station. 32. An underdog, sizable Denver Broncos have defeated the Green Bay Packers 31-24. They did it on the ground with the most valuable player, Terrell Davis, and they did it for their quarterback, John Elway. Davis, by the way, who, as we said, had his number 7 high school number retired, he's the 7th running back to earn the most valuable player honor in the Super Bowl. Jim Gray is down in that bedlam at the floor of Qualcomm.
All right, John Elway now being hugged and congratulated by Mike Shanahan, exchanging some words here. It's been pandemonium down here on the field. John, finally, your thoughts on winning the Super Bowl? It's been a lifetime dream.
It is. I mean, there's
Other than the my wife and my four kids, there's nothing better than this. And I tell you what, it's just, I can't believe it. It's been a lot of work. And with so many things going against us, the AFC, NFC, all that type thing, and it's just, it's unbelievable.
The emotion right now and the sentiment that was going across this country toward you, now that it's culminated, what are your thoughts and emotions?
I mean, I can't even believe it. I appreciate all those thoughts and the prayers and, you know, it's just great. I mean, it's a great organization, and you know what? I'm so proud that, I mean, this team came together. We did it the hard way, and but all, for all our Bronco fans, I've never had this feeling. We finally got it done, and that is really neat.
Did you ever doubt in your mind that you would have a chance to get back at this place? It's taken another 8 or 10 years to get back.
Yeah, you always wonder that, and you wonder that you're gonna, you know, if you're gonna run out of years. But fortunately, I hung on, and Mike came in here and got it done for us.
Final thought here, John, before
go.
They drag you away.
I gotta go.
Will you retire now? Is this the Holy Grail?
I'll talk to you.
All right, he's going to receive the trophy. John Dockery has Terrell Davis.
Thank you, Jim. Great. Terrell Davis, MVP. What's the best part of this game?
Man, I'm numb right now. I can't even reflect on our game right now. I guess it's going to take a while for this to set in.
I saw you talking to number 7. What did you say to him? What do you feel about him finally getting
I just congratulated him, man. I knew it was a long time coming for him. And what can I say, man? This is, I'm numb. I have no idea that this is going on right now.
It's your hometown. Right. You got the most touchdowns rushing by any running back ever, 3. I mean, what a moment for you. Can you define it?
I planned it like that. No, all I want to do is come out here and just play well. Do you know what I do best and just try to run the ball hard and put pressure on our line did a great job. Our line and Howard did an excellent job. All I had to do was run. My job was easy.
Well, you did it. Congratulations. Greg Gumbel, up to you.
Thank you, baby.
The first thing to be said down here on the podium is that the city of San Diego puts on a heck of a show. And the Denver Broncos for the AFC have found the light at the end of the tunnel. To make the presentation of the Vince Lombardi Trophy to the Denver Broncos is the commissioner of the National Football League, Paul Tagliabue.
Pat, Mike, it was a great, great Super Bowl between two outstanding teams. The Packers made a valiant defense of their title, but today our hats off to the Denver Broncos. Congratulations to the Denver Broncos, Mike Shanahan, John Elway, get over here, John, and Pat Bowlen.
Thank you, Paul. Whoa! I often wondered what this would be like. You know, I want to express my appreciation to all my fans, my coaching staff, and all my organization. But there's one thing I want to say here tonight. It's only 4 words. This one's for John.
As much as everyone has wanted this for you, you told me a few weeks ago that you wanted this one just as much for the fans in Denver. And I know that in the media guide, under Pat Bowlen's area, it says, I want us to be first in everything.
I tell you what, I don't even know what to say. I never thought it'd be, I was hoping someday I'd be up here, and today we are. And you can't give enough credit for these two guys right here. They make it all happy. But I tell you what, my teammates, man, it was a team win today. Terrell Davis for running hard. And I tell you what, the fans in Colorado and the Rocky Mountain states that have been with us forever, this one's for you too.
Head coach Mike Shanahan, you and I have wondered privately as to when this AFC losing streak would end. It came to an end today in perhaps the most competitive football game of the season.
I'm proud of our football team, and I thank Pat Bowlen for giving us opportunity to compete. Gave us all the financial resources to get this thing done, and I can't say enough about this team.
Turning points and key points of this game in your mind?
Well, we came up with a couple turnovers, and we overcame the turnovers we made. We had both teams that competed for 60 minutes. Hard-fought game, could have won either way, but I'm very happy the way it turned out and the way our guys fought for 60 minutes.
Green Bay's Eugene Robinson came up with a key interception there. I imagine you had visions of putting this game away early.
Well, you know, they're a great football team. They've made a lot of plays. plays all year. We tried to look Eugene off. He came back and made a play on Rod Smith. But anytime you play a team like the Packers, you got to show up and you got to find a way to win, and that's what happened today.
I know this is where you felt you should have been a year ago, but I imagine it's been worth the wait.
Well, it's not easy. There's a lot of great teams out there and a lot of great organizations. I'm just very proud of this one today.
Okay, our congratulations to the Denver Broncos. Let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Greg. I'm now joined by Neil Smith. You spent 9 years laboring in Kansas City. Your 10th year, you come over to the Broncos. A big pay cut, as we talked about in the pregame. Was it all worth it now?
It was all worth it. I tell you what, you know, the only reason why I came here, for one simple reason, to get this team over the hump and win the World Championship. So, Denver, we bringing it home, baby, because we deserve it. Nobody in the world gave us an opportunity. Nobody picked us. But you know what? I hate the number 13, and we put it to the end, baby, because we the number one champion, baby. And, Mama, I love you.
Neil, let me ask you, because it looked as though it could get away from you very early. Mike Shanahan told the defense, the first 25 plays of this game is critical, because if you get behind 14 or 21 points, they're a much different team. What adjustment did you make when you went down 7-0?
When we went down 7-0, you know, as a defense, we came back on the sideline and we just simply said, hey, you know, let's settle down. You know, we get the kinks out and play our defense. We've been getting turnovers the whole year, and now we have an opportunity to, you know, just to settle down and make plays. And we did. We got the fumbles and we got the turnovers. Those are the big things that make everything win.
Everybody wanted this for number 7, John Elway. The sentiments of the team, if you can express them.
I tell you what, you know, that's one of the reasons why I came. I'm happy for John. I'm happy that John made room for me to get here. And I'm enjoying every moment with him. And you know what? Only thing I can say that's going to end the chapter in my book, because I played with some Hall of Fame guys and Joe Montana and also Marcus Allen. I got one that's here that's going to go down too, baby, being number 1. So all the Super Bowls he fell short, this is the one that count, baby. This is the one that count. He deserves it.
Doesn't really matter now. Neil, congratulations. Let's send it upstairs now to Dick Enberg.
We said at the start of the telecast during the introduction of the lineups, these are just little kids with the same dream every kid has that puts on a helmet, but big bodies surround them, and you see the child in all these men tonight. The wild card road to a Super Bowl championship is almost impossible. For only the second time, the wild card team has held that treasured Lombardi Trophy.